be like, I'm staying over here with the crowd.
Poor girl, I'm done.
Smart man, smart young man. I'm staying over here with the crowd. Clapping people, yeah. Clapping people, buddy, high five.
All right, news for you all. Shadow government, what's that about?
A hidden government? A hidden government?
All right, now, go ahead, now speak.
A hidden government, a government behind another government,
well,
possibly
yes.
puppeteering yes. the visible government?
Yes.
There's an outward government, but then there's another government, an interior government that's controlling, like I said, puppeteering the outer government.
That's cool.
That's controlling the masses. Mm-hmm. Does she understand?
Little mama.
It's like Sesame Street. Then you know, like there's a hand controlling the puppet. You know,
you see the puppet. No,
yeah, you see. Okay, yeah, you see the puppet, and you think you all right. Okay, all right. It's just all right. You see the puppet. It's like
you
get carried away.
You was wrong.
Okay, all right. Okay, so you see.
Make it elementary.
All right.
And when you stretch it like this.
All right, you see the puppet, and then you get. You see the puppet, but then there's a hand that's guiding that puppet, that's causing it to speak. The puppet, in and of itself, doesn't have a life of its own. If you took the hand away, then
the puppet. My eyebrows raising.
I mean, that's extended my knowledge.
All right, good.
When you look at the letter that was written to Pope Paul, his government, Vatican, the America Major, and the United States of America, America Minor, and he's in control.
Yeah, let's not talk about control. We're talking about shadow government.
Yeah, well, that's
now, which one is the shadow government?
The American Minor.
Which one of what you just said is the shadow government? Yeah. And you would have answered that like 2 and 2 is 4. That's why we're redundant.
Yeah.
All right, just a reminder. Because everybody must be clear on that, including baby girl. Because what you're doing now is setting the groundwork so that she doesn't have to go. That it becomes natural to her. That's why we're doing what we're doing. All right? Anybody else? Shadow government? How about y'all?
Right.
Y'all ducking?
It's a fake government.
Well, exactly true, yes.
It's a fake government that is acting in power but isn't in power.
Say it all louder.
A fake government that is acting in power but it isn't with a real government.
You've been studying it.
We brought her for you to pick on her because she's in the house acting like she don't. So we brought her to Daddy Tosh today.
Go ahead, go study. This is the hand. That's a very good answer. Very good answer. Yours was correct. That was even more correct. Now, close the answer out. Now, this is what we want to make sure that you know what the close out is, all right? So now, in law, when you are making an argument on an issue, you can describe the argument. You can refine the argument. You must name the parties, though. Are we clear? You can have a great argument. Don't name the parties, your argument fails. Again, that's why we're redundant. Are we clear? Everybody clear?
Clear.
Excuse the scribble. Casablanca. Say again? Don't say it with a question mark.
White House.
Exactly. Now that's how you're supposed to talk. With authority. White House.
Daddy.
All right. So. How many of you are aware of the fall of the Emirate Palace in Al-Andalus in 1492? Raise your hand if you are. Don't raise your hand if you're not. So many things you're going to write down because everything I'm not going to necessarily put on the board. But I saw it. Almost raised hand. Anybody else? The fall of the palace of the Emirates, 1492, is the fall of the Red House. Right? The Red House. And Alhambra is the Red House. All clear. Y'all got that? You got that, little mama? You just saying that. Because you be just going along, you know. You got that? Alhambra. Means Red House. All right? That's the palace, the Emirates Palace in Al-Andalus that is later, not at that time, later in history called Spain. Are we clear? 1492. Evolving, say it again. Say it again.
Is
that
the
same year? Yeah, well, that's the thing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you're harmonizing. Because it's related.
Is that the one that was
supposed to be
huh? The. I can't hear you.
Yeah, speak a little louder, y'all, because they got soft voice, because they're singers.
No, I was asking, I was watching something on, I think, TV, and they were speaking about Isabel and Fernando.
Exactly. Exactly.
Thank you.
Exactly. Now, the fall of the Alhambra which is Red House. I'm just making some reference points for you, and a lot of the other stuff you have to put together in your mind, all right? All right? The fall of the Alhambra, 1492. That's Granada. In Granada, Al-Andalus, that they later, so in order for you, your concepts to be right, keep in mind, that area was not called Spain at the time. That, when you get that in history, that's a retroactive introduction. Are we clear?
Yes.
So when you're reading history, your concept will be that the Moors in Spain, like you'll even see some scholars write about the Moors in Spain, the Moors in Al-Andalus, which is called Spain after the fall. It was called Spain after. It really wasn't called Spain until about 1600s. Are we clear? That area is Al-Andalus. And in the feminine, Al-Andalusia.
Can you spell it?
I was trying not to avoid spell. I was trying to avoid using the word. Al, A-L, A-N, D-A, L-U-S. Now, the reason I'm telling you this is so that you'll have a better understanding of the history thereafter on our mainlands of the Americas. Are we clear? Because it's not the beginning, but these are keys to the politics that are going on now. Where we're going at right now is to give you a clarity of the politics that's operative right now at Northwest America, North America, all right? And Central and South America, all right? The occupation, and thus the politics. Distinguished from what you're told, are we clear? Are we clear? So, if we're going to solve problems, we got to know what we're dealing with. And what you discover is most of our people don't know the history and therefore don't even know what they're dealing with and don't know how to deal with it anyway. Are we clear? That's what we're going through this. All right? Now, so I'm trying to avoid using up the board. So I'm depending on you to write down some of these things, all right? And just use these as mental reference points, all right? Now, with the fall of the palace, that is not the beginning of the fall, and it is not the end of the fall. It's a major landmark stage in the fall of the Moorish Empire. Are we clear? Are we clear? Including the Battle of 1812 on Lake Michigan, too. So you got to understand that these are sequential. But I'm mentioning these things because it's important for you to have a concept of the politics that you're dealing with. All right?
I'm recording you on my audio.
Oh, sure. All right. And keep in mind, what we're talking about is taught to Europeans and also to Masons and people in secret societies, but it's codified. Are we clear?
Oh.
This is to keep it from you. Do you understand? That's why I want you to try to remember some things, because we need this whole board, basically, to, you know, to give you some sequentials. Keep in mind, we got our arm here, sir. Thanks.
When we were coming, we were going to stop and buy you, because on the good news, you're always running out of markers and dry. So we were going to buy you something else.
Makes a big difference. Because the other one, that one belonged to a union, because it just didn't stop erasing. You know, what you want to look at when you're looking at this is basically your understanding why everyone in positions of power in the contemporary world must be a Mason. How many of you ever been or participated in or been a member of the Nation of Islam? All right, actual fact. What is a Mason? Said answer. Well, that's true, but that's not the answer that I'm looking for. That's why I asked, because I'm going to actual facts. In the Nation of, no, you're not wrong, so don't misunderstand. What I'm asking, in the Nation of Islam, you're given lessons. There's one of the actual facts that is given for instruction. And one of the questions is, what is a Mason? Then you give the answer that the Honorable Elijah Muhammad presented. What's the answer?
Mother's son.
No, that's your knowing as you study. That's not the answer to the actual facts. A Mason is a Muslim son. That's the answer. In the Nation of Islam. In other words, you're giving. The Honorable Elijah Muhammad gave keys, but just like any other operation, they expect people to study.
Ah, so in other words, it's kind of like a code?
Like Muslim.
It's direct, Muslim, but not necessarily understood if you don't study.
Okay.
You know how, like, people have a tendency, you give them answers, they have a tendency to be like parrots. They repeat the answer, but upon examination, they don't necessarily understand what you just told them.
Right, because I don't understand what you just said.
All right, now. All right, listen. I want to repeat it again. In the Nation of Islam, you have lessons. We're talking about written lessons. We're not talking just the orations. Written lessons. Amongst what is called the actual facts. One of the questions is, what is a Mason? The answer is, a Mason is a Muslim son. All right? Now, there's multiple directions that that answer leads you to if you study. If you don't, you just repeat it to pass the test. But he's telling you this history. In other words, if you study, you'll come to this history. If you don't study, you just repeat it because everybody repeats it. You know, like they tell you test. How much is 1 and 1? 2! You know, everybody says it, man. You know, you ask them to refine it, then they start, I was getting there, and they start that kind of stuff. You know, their concept is not there yet.
So there's a verification.
It's more to it. That's what I'm saying. Do you understand? All right, let me just throw some things at you. Say a brother, sister in the Nation, and they study Islam Diyat.
Oh.
This is to give you a sense of the politics. So you'll have to excuse my scribble. So, Red House, White House. Both Morocco. Morocco, part of the empire in Al-Andalus, Morocco, northwest of Mexico. Are we clear? This is key because they give you the misinformation in this period of time with the Colombian story and with Pedro the Moor navigating the El Nino, and he navigates them and takes them to the last of the Atlantis Islands, which includes Boricane, Dominica, Haiti, etc., that last string of islands of the Atlantis. That's the last of the Atlantis Islands. Are we clear? Are you familiar? All right, good. Where's the other mic too? All right, good. So if anybody wants to speak, use the mic so that you're on tape. You know, like, some of you are familiar, some of you may not be. But whenever you look at any of the secret societies, you will see all of their regalia and all of the symbolisms that they use are Eastern, which they refer to Eastern. Are we clear? This is why. Are we clear? Now, you also understand, I know you may have heard in school where the so-called founding fathers had Korans.
The Altars?
That's why.
The Altars?
But you need to understand why, not just that they did. Do you understand? It has to make sense to you so that, because basically what we're doing is we're putting you back mentally into your proper place in history. This is why we're going through this. Are we clear? Because most of our people speak of themselves in what is known as third person when it comes to the history, only because they don't recognize themselves. Are we clear? So they always speak of their own pedigree like it's some other people. And they refer to themselves by the brand systems that the Europeans gave them. You understand? Those brand systems are Negro, Black, Color, Latino, those type of brands. None of them are real. But that's what our people are used to using when actually they're descendants of the Moors who were defeated. Are we clear? And so even when you see the Europeans making the grand effort to block history, this is why. Because you're the heirs of this estate, this large estate. And all of the colonial debts that was accrued since the Civil War are leaned against the Moorish Empire, i.e. the heirs of the estate, you. This is where your economic problems come from. Do you understand why the redundancy is necessary? Because most of the people don't know that. They have no idea that that's what's going on. They have no idea why poverty is in our communities. They think it's just because they don't have a job or something like that. It's not at all it. Are we clear? And what we want you to do is use your intelligence and start connecting the dots and understand what we're saying to you. Because it is you that have to help cure this. Meaning that me or anyone who has this knowledge who's telling you this is not good enough. It must become your own. Are we clear? And when you answer, just like when you answered a little while ago, and I said answer with authority and power, confidence. Do you understand? Yes. Because it has to be a part of you. And as long as it's not a part of you, you will be declared as incompetent. If you don't answer with strength, confidence, you will be declared incompetent. This is why certain things we're redundant with. Are we clear? And it's not to bore you. It is to get it solidly in your head. Because you need to know, particularly now, you really need to know this. And this is in particular because the European is under pressure, and what you have is transference of some, the most major financial instruments on the planet are being neutralized. And so you will be affected adversely. Yes. Meaning that what you call JOBs and stuff like that, you're going to be affected adversely. Things that you have looked at or that you've depended on as what you might call or think is your security are going to be neutralized. Are we clear? So it's important for you to have this information because you're going to have a sense of knowing what to do other than what you've been doing. Are we clear? Because if you think you're not going to be doing something different, don't hold your breath, because you will be. So if you're depending on the system for sustenance, don't hold your breath. And get prepared to move with the changes that are definitely coming, not maybe, definitely coming, are we clear? And in order to understand it, you must know what's happening, can't be guessing. I feel as though in my opinion, you can't do that. You need to understand the real politics, the shadow government. Are we clear? Now, we went over this a couple of times, and since last time, you know, I've been in a couple other parts of the country, and we've talked to people, many who are scholars, and they still don't have, they're not solid in this history background. Do you understand? Which makes them ineffective. Because this is where your problems are rooted. This is where your economic problems are rooted. And not knowing it puts you at a supreme disadvantage. Are we clear? All right. I'll make that very clear. So, with the fall of the Emirate, that's the Red House, Alhambra, that's where Michelle went. Remember when Obama went to Egypt? And keep these things in mind, because we're not going to write all these things down. You're to write them down. When Obama went to Egypt, and he exposed that the American Constitution comes from Muslim law, he's sending you to this history. All right? Without going into heavy detail. Then he goes to Article 11 of the Treaty of Tripoli, and he mentions 1790. And then he mentions the relationship between the United States and Morocco. He's pointing you to this history. But it's incumbent upon you to fill in the slots, to fill in the holes. Even like, say, as we're here, right? We're here a couple of hours. And there's no way that we're going to give you or undo what Rome has had years to do. That's why I'm giving you, you know, key points, what you call landmark points. Depending on you to expand your thinking and to do some research. I know she had the Black's Law Dictionary, see, because that's what's going to happen. Then you also want to have a dictionary etymology on the English language. You want to have the older history books. You go to flea markets and stuff, don't hesitate to get those old books. That's where the knowledge is, I'm clear. The older encyclopedias that everybody wants to throw away thinking that they're updated. Do you understand what I'm saying? Those are valuable books, all right? All of the later books are heavily edited, are we clear? Because you have what is called a staged, deliberate, dumbed down to make the people docile, all right? So let's talk a little bit. And we've talked about this before, but I want to talk about this and give you some understanding. Now, when you look at the White House and the Red House, they had a movie called Casablanca with, I think it was George Raft. and some oldie movies. George Wilder. And
Humphrey Bogart.
Is that Humphrey Bogart?
Mm-hmm.
That was Bogart.
Yeah.
Anyway. They had one of the Emmerich's daughters. He was checking her out, but they have her European eyes anyway. But really, they're talking about Casablanca. They're really talking about the White House right here in Washington. Do you understand what I'm saying? But they know these are codes, but they know that the people don't know the history, so they can make movies and tell you stuff. I mean, you know, unless you're a Mason or Eastern Star or somebody, Skull and Bones or Knights Templar, you know, in one of the secret societies, you'll know what they're talking about. But most of the average people, it goes right over their heads. It's just another movie. So they can talk to people in front of you or under your nose. You know, how they have a conveyor belt with doo-doo more than like you think it's peanut butter? Everybody else knows the doo-doo. They going like this, you're going,
does that look like peanut butter?
You know, you're the only one that don't know what's up. Types of books, kind of like what we're holding. That's how they operate. All right? All right, now, so keep this in mind, y'all. White House, Red House, White House. Red House falls, White House falls. All right? And so, this symbolizes when the European moved the government from Philadelphia to Washington. That's what that symbolizes.
House.
The Casablanca story.
The house.
Are we clear? And then, of course, George Washington's monument is an obelisk. Because he converted our estates into the states. Are we clear? Are we clear? So it's important for you to understand these things, to understand the shadow government that's operating now. Now, me and Dr. Naila, we had a lightweight conversation, and if you feel to interject, don't hesitate to interject. And it's important to understand this because you have to prepare for what's coming up. Keep going.
I just want to hold it.
You're getting ready to do a ventriloquist thing. Anyway, but this is important for you to understand that when the Red House fell, they set up the Global World Trust. Write that down.
Write
it down. All right, say it. Tell what to do. Say, write that down.
Write it down.
All right. Woo! Glad you brought him, man. Brother, stop with me. Say that one more time, brother.
Say, write it down.
Tell him, write that down.
Say, tell him.
Tell them
right there. Global World. There you go. Global World Trust. Now, as you all know, because some of you are young, y'all still are babies. So, y'all are babies. And that's a baby. But some of the others of you know in the last, say, 20, 25 years, you've been hearing things like the HMOs, site drafts, then the UCCs, then financial statements, etc. UCC-1 financial statements, etc. Now they're trying to authenticate the birth certificate. Understand that all of those processes are connected to the Global World Trust. How many people knew that?
No.
I want y'all to look around the room, see, because I'm trying. I need to know where you are with this. Now, Heru raised his hand. But notice how.
Oh, she dead?
No other hands are raised. But I guarantee you, there's a handful of these people in here that's either used UCCs, done financial statements, or trying to authenticate a birth certificate and don't know anything about the World Global Trust. Yeah. Your claim is incompetent.
That's right.
And I'm going to reiterate this to make you understand when we opened up and I say, why is it some things we must be redundant with? Because it's just like getting in the boxing ring, or we get in the boxing ring, right? So you're training me, right? You training me, say, well, Taji guy, see, you move like this, and see, then you keep your hand up like this and everything, and I'll be going like this, right? Then I get hooked a couple times, and I start talking about the ref jumping me and everything, and then you'd be saying, no, please, no, he didn't. You know that, I know what he did. Because when you get in the ring, they're going to be trying to take your head off. Likewise, when you're out in the real world, that shadow government is what's operating. And if you don't understand that that's what's in operation, you will get injured. Because it's already planned for you to get injured. Because you're under occupation. One of the hardest things to do to get into our people's heads is to get them to understand that they're under occupation. Do you? You know how people are always talking about racism and prejudice? Do you know why they're talking about racism and prejudice?
Out of ignorance?
When you hear our people always talking about racism and prejudice when it comes to our social, spiritual, economic problems in our communities, do you know why they're always saying that? There's a duplication of trainings that they did with little rats that they applied to humans. Because it's not really what's going on. And when you start arguing that, they already declared you incompetent. You just didn't know it. Because it's not what's happening. You're under European colonial occupation. Don't start talking racism and prejudice. It's a diversion argument. Are we clear? You're under European colonial occupation, shadow government. Are we clear?
Clear.
And back to what we was talking about earlier, what's happening is that different corporate entities are having to consolidate. And even after they consolidate, they'll still probably start being dismantled. Things are going on to stop things from just collapsing, but understand things will be dismantled. They will be disrupted. Are we clear?
Clear.
And so you're giving this information so that you can prepare yourselves and prepare your families. That's why you're giving this information. You're giving this information actually years before certain things take place to prepare you. Guess what happens if you don't get prepared?
Get hooked.
You become part of the rubble. Because it's already planned. Meaning that whatever value you have, don't waste it on things that are not needed or not necessary. Put it into something that's hard asset so that you can survive and your family can survive at least 6 months. Because you may not make it through that if you're one that didn't listen to what we've been telling you for these years. When we were coming down, the traffic was kind of jammed a little bit. Sister Sandra said, wow, look at those clouds. They look kind of weird. Right here, so yeah, it's because they're chem clouds. Don't train them to be chem clouds. You know, because they're trying to kill people off. This is aside from nanoviruses and stuff. So if you take your children from school, do not let them stick them. Because they're going to put nanoviruses in. So, I mean, you already know that, so there you go. There's no need to, you know, keep discussing it. That's what's up. Are we clear? Now, let's get back to our point, and I'm going to try to give you some things to look at. We talked about this before. Take these short notes, these like bullet points. George Washington was the 9th president and not the first. So you don't get it twisted. All right. George Washington is the preacher who converted the Moorish estates into the corporate states under the secret treaty of Verona for European operations on the land. Are we clear? Preter, that's actually, that's A-E with an A-E. Preter. Preter is what they call the presidents, they're Roman praetors.
Can you repeat it?
P-R-A.
No, what you just said about George Washington.
Oh, George Washington, well, these are things that you need to remember, so write them down if you need to, was the ninth president and not the first. And part of what I'm telling you, you can just try to put it to memory. They tell you that because they want to lock you out of examining the administrations that preceded him, because it'll start tying you back to some keys that'll take you back to true history. That's why you're given that as a reference point. You know, was, you know how they start you off in the middle race and you don't understand what the beginning line is? And it never dawns on you that, that you've been played. You understand? Now remember, let's go through the scenario again and then feel free to talk too, all right? 1492, as the Emirate fell in Granada, that's in Al-Andalus, that's later, not at that time, later called Spain, are we clear? All right. It is one of the major events in the fall of the Moorish Empire. It's not complete. It's one of the major events. And therefore, that date, 1492, is used historically among scholars as the turning point, or what you call the axis year, between the old world and the new world. So when they talk about after 1492, they're talking new world. 1492 back, they're talking old world. Old world is you. New world is European colonial operations, the shadow government. It's not solidly established yet, but that's what you need to understand, all right? So, it is not unlike, we taking you and sitting you over here and telling you somebody else is your mother. And after a couple of years, you believe it, and that's what's happening. And everybody else believes it. Meanwhile, you're not heritable because you're not tied to your real mother. But you don't know that. This is exactly what's happening to our people. Exactly, in fact. And this is where you get parens patriae that is used in the United States corporation government in relationship to 14th Amendment persons. Except instead of the mother, it is dealing with the father, being the Pope of Rome, who's imitating the Pharaoh Ptah of Egypt. And the substitute for the Christ degree on the spiritual plane. Thus, claiming to be God on earth. So when you go home, look in your Bible, read 1st and 2nd Thessalonians. I won't go through it. I'm just giving you reference points so that you can understand the spiritual reflection into the politics as operative. So that you don't get the idea that what people keep calling spiritual and that the politics have no relationship. They absolutely have tons of relationship. Are we clear? And it's not that you haven't been told these things, it's that it hasn't been explained to you. Do you understand? In other words, people usually use the information to spook you up and take your finance rather than tell you the Kabbalistic origin of those books, and that those books are actually astrological projections so that you could prepare for the roadblocks that are put in your way. That's what's called prophecy. Prophecy is really astrological projections. If you didn't know it now. So it ain't about being spooky, so don't get spooked about it. All clear? The Bible is an astrology book, and it's not their book, it's yours. So don't look at it like, oh, it's a European. No, he tampered with it, but it still is not his book. Are we clear? All right. So don't get this idea. See, this is another trap, too. Like when you get our people and they get into different, what they call, what they're calling different religions, really only one religion, but people get into what they call different religions, Islam, Judaism, Christianity, Buddhism, and then they get into multiple, and I mean multiple different sects and denominations. Demon, keep this in mind because these are codes. Right? Yes, and this is where they go to and forth the earth, devouring nations, seeking whom they may devour. And this would also be referred to as sects.
Say yes to him.
Yeah, he's got a genuine, authentic emo shirt on.
Elmo.
Excuse me, y'all. You got the camera on that?
That's Elmo. Yes. Camera's on. That's
Elmo.
And he's wearing a rose quartz crystal.
Yes, he does.
Does crystal on too?
Rose quartz?
Yes. Yes. Yes.
In the right place. But he got that from the house around.
Yeah. All right.
Okay, you got a little celebrity in the house, y'all. Anyway. One of the problems that we have, too, is that the masses have no idea that there really is not and never has been separation of church and state. The states are the corporate entities of the church. Lost to the Jesuits. You know what he talked about Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde, the movie? They're really talking about Jekyll Island.
Wow.
Georgia. That's where they created the shadow government. Are we clear? And it's important for you to understand this because you're under psychic attack. And they're getting ready to accelerate their economic attack on you. Knowing this, just give your heads up. Y'all have known this for a while. They intend to exercise this, so don't think that they're not going to. Even though there's some interventions that are taking place, but it can, how do you say, slow down the hemorrhaging. Can't stop. In other words, you have to take some responsibility in this. Translation, save yourselves. Physicians, heal yourselves. All those different statements, many of the statements that you've heard people propose that Jesus said were actually for you. And you know that Jesus is a password. Jesus actually is a code for justice. And so Jesus is missing. Justice is missing. Jesus was hung on a cross. Justice was hung on a cross. And so justice must be resurrected.
SMS
but it must be resurrected in you. And thus you must have the knowledge of what killed you. But you weren't really dead. This is why you'll see, if you travel the country and you'll see where they may have oil paintings of George Washington closing the lodge, you'll see him closing the lodge like this. Whoa. Which means we're not dead. They buried us. They struck us in the head. But we're not dead. That's what that means. And so you must resurrect. You must dig. You know what we said a few years ago? I think we said it a couple times when we told people, you know, when they talk about different problems that we have. We said, this is the day, this is the time that you must prove your God. When man unfolds, his God unfolds. Call him immediately, because you're going to need him. And the ones that ain't real will be running. Meaning if it don't work, don't keep appealing. So you're going to have to go to the depths of your mind and the depths of your heart with sincerity and call on whatever you claim to your God is. Because this is the time that you're going to be challenged by divine law to prove your claim, not what somebody else says. Not what somebody else says. What you said. Guess what happens if you fail?
Death.
In other words, like, you know how like when Yahshua said to Peter said, yeah, I'm your boy, man. Yeah, we boys, man, we've been rolling and everything. And then Jesus said, oh, we boys, huh? Get out the boat. Walk the water. Translation, oh, you bad? You say you spiritual? Get out the boat. Yeah, we boys, I'm rolling down with you. All right, good. No problem. Get out the boat, Peter. Walk the water. Pete starts singing, didn't he? Mm-hmm. Making claims that he couldn't back up. That's what it means. Are we clear? Sincerity is key. Because Mother Nature will not come to your rescue if you're not sincere. However, she has come to claim her own. You can decide what you want to do or what you don't want to do. It's on you. But you're not going to say that you aren't told. You ain't going to get away with it. All right? So let's talk about Shadow Realm. Now, scenario. But this is the truth. This is the real truth. Who was the mini minister's plenipotentiary 1784 under the protection of Sidi Muhammad, Sultan of Morocco, when the negotiations were introduced for a treaty of operations for the Europeans operating at Morocco? Stand up, give your brother a mic. Oh, we should have had a camera, put the camera on the TV doing that. Well, I can believe you washed the dishes, man.
We're waiting in line.
We're washing the dishes. Let me show this people this film.
All right. George Washington, John Adams, Thomas Jefferson, I think Thomas Barclay.
And agent in business.
Yeah. And that's all
I know. Right.
Negotiate the treaty. That's where you get potentate and masonry. Ministers, plenty, potential. All right? Keep this in mind. Now, before the negotiations, because you got to remember, with the fall of the Emirate, go ahead, talk. Give him the mic.
You want to know about the Barbary trees or the one before?
No, I want you to have the concept on these ministers.
Right.
We're timeline. We're looking at timeline.
Timeline.
1784.
In May of 1784, the American commissioners in Paris, Benjamin Franklin, John Adams, Thomas Jefferson were authorized by Congress.
What's
So repeat after me. Say, in May In May 1784, the American commissioners in Paris, Benjamin Franklin, John Adams, Thomas Jefferson, were authorized by Congress to conclude treaties of friendship and commerce with Morocco, Algiers, Tunis, T-U-N-I-S, and Tripoli. All right. 1785.
Now, those are different parts of the empire. And the Treaty of Tripoli is what Obama was talking about, 1790. See, so you have to put this in perspective so you can understand how this came about. So you got to know history. Are we clear? And that history must be put in context for the coming generations, because they're not given this history. Even most of the adults don't have this history. Do you understand? And when it's given, it's not given in context. Do you understand? Therefore, you don't perceive what's being told to you. All right? All right, so let's go through this scenario. What's happening? When the Red House fell, that's the Alhambra, the Red House. All right? That's why Michelle went there as a signal. That's why she wore a red dress. Are we clear? Mm-hmm. You gotta understand these Dorothy thing. Wow. All right, yeah. 1492. Jump up. Treaty of Peace and Friendship finalized. 1786, 1787. Supported by the ordinance of 1787. Then the affirmation of the Constitution for the United States, 1787, ratified 1788, finalized 1789. At that time, George Washington was appointed to the seat that was actually being prepared for Benjamin Franklin. Are we clear? Are we clear? Benjamin Franklin was one of the ministers plenipotentiary during the construction and negotiations of the treaty. This is what's important for you to understand. As the European was being brought into government, secretly the mission to continue the Inquisition operations and the secret Treaty of Verona was continued but covered up, are we clear? Meaning that they were pretending that they want to honor the Treaty of Peace and Friendship, but their real intention was to get a foothold in Morocco. That's in the west, or what's called the Maghreb. Maghreb, Morocco, most extreme west. Do you understand? This is basically what that French Muslim told Malcolm when he told him that you left home, you just because you made the highs, don't get it twisted. Like the Europeans don't know Islam. You don't know Islam. Don't come in there, white and black stuff. That's what if you, without going too deep in it, that's what he's telling you. You don't know the real history. That's what he's really telling you. Not only that, North America's Morocco, you left home, that you don't even know the real history. You think you know Islam, but you don't know Islam. So don't come with that white and black stuff and that arrogant self-righteousness. Because it ain't working. Do you understand? And that wasn't a knock at Malcolm, that was a raising. He raised Malcolm. That means he raised him in degrees. I mean, he jumped him in degrees. Do you understand what I'm saying to you? Because most men travel for generations to pay thousands and 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 thousands of notes before they get to that degree, and even then they can't talk. Do you understand what I'm saying to you? All right. So keep in mind, Benjamin Franklin set up a United States Corporation Service Company. Write that down. United States Corporation Service Company in France. It's important for you to understand that. So we will symbolize that as this little building over here is a service company in France, all right? right? France, United States, service company. Ben Franklin. This was up in 1754, ahead of time, and this corporation is to take care of the service contracts for this union that's going to take place in the future that's already being planned. In other words, the service contracts are what is called the 19 enumerated powers. Write that down. 19 enumerated powers. They were already preparing to service this union that's coming up, which becomes the United States Republic. Are we clear? Are we clear? Now, before it's the United States Republic, it's Republica en Americanos. It's the Moorish Republic Society of Islam. Do you understand? Republica al Moroccanos. That's A-E by itself, and then A-L, Moroccanos. That's M-A-U-R-I-K-A-N-O-S. And Republica, that's with an A, that's with a C-A-E at the end. That becomes what you know later as the United States Republic at North America. That's the union. That's the agreement between the Europeans and the Moors. Are we clear? The deists. And understand the so-called founding fathers were deists. They were not Christians, they were deists. All right? These things are important for you to understand the conflicts, the political conflicts that are apparent in government, that if you don't know this history, you will not understand. All right? We give you this history so you have a better understanding. And also that people can't fool you. Are we clear? Are we clear?
Yes.
Now, keep this in mind. Keep this in mind, that corporation company in France, set up by Benjamin Franklin to service. This is why when the signing of the treaty took place, Franklin was actually in Paris. Now you understand what the treaty, all right. Now, and for some of you who know a little bit of this history, and look at the betrayals that began to manifest across the Americas, you'll understand why Toussaint set up the Republic in 80. And also why they tagged him and got rid of him. To preserve the Republic that was being dismantled. Are we clear? This is another reason why the Europeans made a pact to never let Haiti rise again. They only let them have one airport, and that's only so they can keep control. And then the Franciscan Brotherhood, France, keeping Haiti in debt to France under the secret treaty of Verona. You gotta know the real history here so you know what's happening to you. And so that you can have some kind of a countermeasure, because if you don't know your history, you're not gonna fix anything. Are we clear? Are we clear? All right. Now, let's jump history a little bit, you all. Now you already know that George was really the 9th president. Now let's jump a couple of degrees to Lincoln. And this will give you some keys, because you also notice how they tie their celebrations together, George Washington and Lincoln celebration, right? To the masses, it's like a convenience, holiday convenience. No, there's a relationship. See, George Washington converted the Moorish estates into states, and Lincoln was unraveling it. This is why the original operations of the Emancipation Proclamation included the 40 acres and a mule to every man, woman, and child, which would have essentially given all the land back that was being usurped. Go West, young man. The land patents and everything that they was giving to the Europeans to steal our land. You got, give me these keys so you can understand history. Do you understand? Now listen, this is very important for you to understand. According to fatwa, is law. That's Moorish law, fatwa. In accord with fatwa, a member of the barristers could not hold an office in this new union called the United States Republic. Now remember, Barack H. Obama gave a code when he went to Egypt, and he said, the American Constitution comes from Muslim law.
Yes, he did.
He's sending you right back to his history. Then he goes to Article 11 of the Treaty of Tripoli, sending you back to his history. But he's expecting you to fill it in. He can't go so far without getting killed. Do you understand? You understand? All right. He's doing what he can, what his assignment is. All right? He's a spokesman for the United States Corporation Company. Are we clear? He's the CEO for the corporation, although the seat is dead. Are we clear? You need to know that the presidential seat is dead. He's acting as a spokesman. How many of you all seen that dinner where he's holding a mic like this and he says, and he's talking about the end of the Republic, and he says, Obama, out, and he drops the mic like this. He's telling you that the seat is there. In other words, what we're talking about to you should have been told to you generations ago. So if some of it appears, kind of goes over your head, don't worry about it. Just pay attention to these cornerstones that I'm giving you. And the rest of it will fall in due time, especially when you go to sleep, because the memory's already in you anyway. I'm just smacking you around a little bit to agitate you. And Mother Nature will wake you up and take you into a national travel and give you a rest and go back to where you need to be, clean your mind up. Slumber, give him the mic. Slumber, brother.
How are you?
All right, brother.
Peace you all.
Go ahead. Give him the mic.
What is the presidential seat? Was it something that was historically dead all along? Or was it?
It was, but it's officially, not that it wasn't. It really was. See, they've been operating colorably since 1861. Technically, the seat's been dead since then. Not actually dead, but shadowed. Shadowed, that's what it was, shadowed, which means it was silent. The best way to put it is an impostorship. It's been impostor activities in the federal government of the United States, but not for the United States, since 1861, May the 10th. This is why you got to know the history, you know. And we'll get to that, but I want you, you're on key. I want you to know that you're on key.
Now, when the Pope came, okay, and he wrote that letter to Obama.
He's telling you part of this history. He's giving you markers He's given you markers and code words to tell you this history. Remember, he owns all the world's corporate entities. Think Thessalonians 1 and 2. Yahshua, remember when I was yet with you, I told you these things that they would ascend the throne of God, sitting themselves on the throne of God, claiming to be God.
Yes.
This is where you get the title, the sub part of the title, Vicar. Write that down, V-I-C-A-R. So when you refer to Vicar, that's a substitute. So he's a substitute for Ptah. So keep this in mind. What's the proper name for Egypt? So what is Ptah in Egyptian lore and Kabbalistic philosophy? The maker of gods and men. So the Pope of Rome is a substitute for Ptah, thus he is the world pharaoh. And he's also the substitute for the Christ degree. And so he's called the vicar of Christ. See, they mentioned Yahshua. So now he takes his place. Everything is based on the substitute. Everything is based on impersonation. Everything's based on a shadow. I'm showing you the connection in history and in politics. D, give D the mic. She's been practicing her song. I think she has the sheet music too.
The word antichrist itself is Greek, and anti means substitute, you know, Christ, all right? So the antichrist would actually be the vicar or the Pope himself.
Yes. Now, shadow government, this is what's happening. And the reason I brought this up, actually because of our conversation, Dr. Nayo, you know, and not that we haven't talked about this, but this has to be refined in your mind. Because how you regurgitate this, meaning how you baptize with this in your own mind, has much to do with Goliath falling. Goliath must fall in your mind before he falls in the real world. And the key to your comprehension of taking Goliath's head is sincerity. Therefore, it's important for you to understand what you're dealing with in order for you to vibrate in harmony with the cell memory that's already in you in order for it to wake up. Are we clear? Clear. Meaning that it's dormant.
Clear.
It's, I'm not really telling you anything you don't know. You, put it this way. So don't think that you don't know what I'm talking about. Just say that you forgot some of this stuff. And some of you think because you got new bodies, and I'm going to repeat that. Some of you think because you have new bodies, think that you're new. But you're not. So just keep that in mind while we're talking. All right? So don't get confused about the human species. And don't get confused about that baby in his arms either. Go ahead, brother. Give him a mic.
Just as a reference or question. Are you familiar with the, there's a movie called Selfless, where they, where they have the ability to basically take a person and move their consciousness to another body. And what they do is they give them this pill that they take. and they have to take this pill whenever they experience memories from the other person's consciousness. So those pills that they're giving them is slowly killing off the other person's consciousness while you take over their body.
Or sleep.
Or sleep, correct. Yeah.
This is what this psychological operation is for. In other words, dogmata, this, since you brought that up, dogmata is counterfeit religion, which was given to you to stagnate the pioneer land, i.e. to put you to sleep. This is why sometimes we remind people, and sometimes people have a tendency to get sensitive because they think we're attacking their beliefs, and we're really not. We're informing them what's going on in the mind control. The masses don't get religion. The masses get dogmata. It stagnates the pineal gland. It's a counter to anointing your head with oil.
Wow.
It's a counter to that. Islam.
On that same vein, just wanted to share that the movie Birth of a Nation, I think that premiered today, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah.
Was an article in our local news about the Nat Turner Rebellion. Mm-hmm. Talks about how he was sold out, or I guess it would be rented out, sort of, mm-hmm. to white men to preach on their, I guess, various plantations to keep the slaves in check. Mm-hmm. And I made a comment that 185 years later, it's still going on.
Mm-hmm.
Particularly, definitely it's happening here.
Yeah.
Because even with the politics that are going on, we have situations where they're courting the preachers to keep their, you know, slaves, if you will, their members in check to think a certain way. And that's the same thing.
In harmony with what you're saying, Dr. Ayala, do the research on the eugenics program, and they tell you bluntly. They tell you
Marcus Sanger.
Bluntly, yes. Do the research on it. And this is another thing that you also need to know, everyone. Adolf Hitler is misrepresented. The programs of psychological warfare, psychic attacks, mind control chemicals, experiments for pain tolerance, skinning people to do different things, to see what their pain tolerance is, was not began with Hitler. It began with the Europeans here occupying North America, and it was presented to him in programs, including the building of 90% of all of the engines for the Third Reich were made right here, including the financial backing him, including the gases that they used in Newark, New Jersey, in unmarked submarines. So when people's idea about the genocide practices that are tagged on Adolf Hitler, understand they were given to him by Europeans here, and it was designed for you. This is why, after they did the experiments on some other people that claim to be Jews that are not Jews, if you read Executive Order 11490, King Alfred Rex 84 plan, you will see that they are preparing it right now to apply to the people here.
Can you quote that number again?
Executive Order 11490, King Alfred, that's the name of the military plan. It's technical manual. And it gives a brief on Europeans in industry and European communities and the police departments, et cetera. An outline is used as a manual. So when you see the things that they're doing to our people on the street and it confuses you, understand they're going by a program manual. And the reason why you see these commercial mercenaries that people are calling policemen, think they're law officers, they're commercial mercenaries. Write that down. You need to remember these things. Commercial mercenaries. And it got done in Briar Street numbers too. And they get so much kickback for certain different organs. Like if they drop a body, you know, they want to, they rather, if they can, choke them out or shoot them in the head, not to injure the organs. Because they get paid for the organs. And the reason why they never go to jail, because it's part of the eugenics program. The BS processes that they go through for the public is because the public is already dumb and docile. Mm. And they believe anything. You know, once they believe that bunny rabbits lay chicken eggs and that Santa Claus really bought them stuff, they're pretty much prepared for everything else. And think that Jesus got a bank account at Chase Manhattan and that Reverend Jones was giving Jesus half and all that stuff. So they already ready. They bought all that, they can buy everything else. Mm-hmm. And that's not, I'm not saying that for humor, it's a fact, because they were already molded from childhood to have that mental state so they could lie to them later. Are we clear? It's a eugenics program. And everybody knows it but our people. And then, just like Dr. Nayibu was saying, the so-called, if you pay attention to the eugenics program, some of the youth are starting to figure this out. You see some of the youth, because some of the youth are kind of sick of this BS. It's why you ever notice that some of these youth in some of these towns, when the usual reverends are interjected after they kill somebody, and here comes the rev to calm them down, and you see some of the youth starting to run them out? Because the youth are starting to figure out that they're COINTELPRO operatives, which they absolutely are. Always were. And this is back to what Dr. Nayo was saying. You know, our people's idea of what they think the clergy is and what the clergy actually is it's a terrible, ugly difference. And so it's not personal against anyone personal. It's for you to really understand what you're dealing with. And our people really don't know what they're dealing with. They really don't. And one of the reasons why the damage has continued is because we are naive as hell. Naive is kind of an understatement. Really, you know, so it's kind of difficult to purge us, you know what I mean? And so it's another reason why it's important for you to know history so that you can free yourself. Because I'm not asking you to believe anything I'm saying. I'm giving you reference points so you can challenge it, prove it untrue. In doing it, you're going to learn other things. It has to become your own. Now, keep this scenario in mind. This service company, 1754, is to deal with the 19 enumerated powers for this evolving union. And that is the Treaty of Peace and Friendship, which establishes the Republic, United States, and North America at Morocco. Are we clear? Now, as mentioned by Dr. Nayila, and I won't get into it, but I just want to give you, you know, just keys to think of. Now you understand why the Birth of a Nation movie was shown in Casablanca first, in the White House, after they moved it to Philadelphia, their palace. From Philadelphia to Washington. And the Birth of a Nation, what it symbolizes is the birth of the shadow government.
That's right.
They're not a nation, they're European colonists who took over.
Yes.
Do you understand? Your concepts must be clear about what you're dealing with. And you know, when you're looking at, you know, Birth of a Nation, or you're looking at them showing you the Asiatics in coattails, you know, in long tail, like tuxedo type, all your congressmen and senators were Asiatics. See, so but people get caught up in the fake race argument and forget what they're looking at. There was a government was overthrown. And they're representing that the red sons and the red queens were beginning to what? Gain power. So who are the red queens? The red queens are the daughters of the American Revolution. That's the European women. They set up the Daughters of the American Revolution. And they construct the citizenship manual that's used at North America and around the world as a pattern. Like, if you come from any other jurisdiction into the direct heartland of the North, you get what's called a DAR manual, D-A-R. That's the Daughters of the American Revolution. And you get citizenship tests before you get a green card. That's the DAR manual. I'm just throwing these things at you so you can start putting things together in your head to understand some things that we're not talking about at this time, but that will start gelling for you. Are we clear? Now, let's go back again. Remember, those of you who do research and you go into microfilm and you go into early newspapers, you will see them having dressed Lincoln in Moorish garb. They will dress Lincoln in Moorish garb with pantaloons and bolero, and also with his two-edged sword with curly hair. They were mocking him because of the Emancipation Proclamation. All right. And this is also why they put Lincoln on the copper penny, because copper is the alchemical metal for Venus, which is your star. You got to understand, different things they do, there's nothing that's done without purpose. Nothing that's done without purpose.
Wow.
Nothing is done without purpose. There are no accidents. All things occur by law. All right? Now, keep this in mind. And you need to understand this in order to understand the shadow government. As we said earlier, Lincoln could not run for president of the Republic because he was a member of the Bar Association, and that's against fatwa, or Moorish law. So they ran Lincoln for president of the service company over here in France, that United States. Do you all have this clear? I need to make sure that you have this very clear. Lincoln, Abraham Lincoln, could not be president or run for president of the Republic, the union between the Moors and the Deists, not because he wasn't worthy, but because he was a member of the Bar Association. And the Bar Association were acting as deputy knights under the secret treaty of Verona to overthrow the Republic. And the secret treaty of Verona was issued along with the operations of the Spanish Inquisition against the Moors. So therefore, a member of the Bar Association could not hold an office in the United States. You need to understand this, to understand the politics, and part of the great Masonic secret, and also why you're not told this information. Use your rational mind. So keep this United States company doing the service contracts for the United States Republic, which is evolving out of the union of the Deists and Republica e Almoricanos, the Moorish Federal Republic. Are we clear? This is why you see the sequence of the ordinance of 1787 before the adoption of the Constitution. The major nature of that was to determine and to make sure that the Aboriginals or the Moors were treated fairly with the Europeans doing business on our land. That's what the ordinance of 1787 is about, all clear. Then the Constitution, 1787, 78, 88, 89, all clear. So that's the major treaty that covers all operations of European operations in the Western Hemisphere. That's why it's the world's longest running treaty, are we clear? It's why Obama addressed it when he went to Egypt. And that's why she, Michelle, went to the Red House, Alhambra. And this is why they had the picture taken of them with the Moorish flag, with the guard standing due guard with the Moorish flag to your left. And then he cut out the stars and stripes. It's over there, but they have a distance. That Stars and Stripes represents the amity and commerce flag for them doing business here. It's not the national flag. Are we clear? Get a brother on the mic.
Islam. So what you're telling me basically is that United States to the right of the board right there is basically an administration?
It's a company to do business. Just like this, like say this. Say Dr. Nayula, but on a more powerful basis. Say this area that we call Wilmington is a regency. And Dr. Nayula is an emirate of this regency, or bay of this regency. That would be a governor. The European convert bay into governor. That's governor is a substitute for the bay. So she's the bay of this area. Do you understand? We're here, and there's politics going on where people are being brought in, and a union is taking place. We get the first contracts to serve this political union to deal with the 19 enumerated powers. So here we set up a corporate entity to do the service contracts, but it's also called the United States. Do you understand that? That's how you look at this, except it's in France. It's a company to do business. You gotta keep in mind that what's called the states now are actually colony businesses that have limited jurisdiction. They just overstepped it later. That's what the overthrow is. That's what the birth of a nation is telling you.
So what services are they providing?
Say again?
So what services are they providing?
Yeah, a provider, I said. The Pope is telling you in that letter. That's why I tell people to read the letter, because he's telling you the history if you know what you're looking at. I'm showing you this so that you can better understand the letter. Because a lot of people read the letter and still don't get it, because more people would be talking about it if they really understood what he's saying. But because the masses have never been given this knowledge, their concepts are entirely wrong. And then they keep looking for benefits that they're not going to damn get. Wasting time. And put it this way. When you don't understand this, you have a tendency to get on a treadmill and gives them time. It gives them what's called a mandate. If our activities are not really addressing what's really wrong, we're giving him time. We give him time. Why do you think the Manchurians and the Russians are telling them, all right, no more shells? Because we appear that we keep on messing around with this thing. We keep on doing other things than what we should be doing. And it's holding up everything. And now, by us being so slow to carry out what we should have been carrying out 100 years ago, nations of the earth are getting ready to collapse because of our tardiness. Our tardiness. And by our people not knowing who they are, they don't know that. See, we've been minimized for so many generations that we don't know our importance. It's not an arrogant statement. We are the direct heirs to the world's largest estate. It's been delivered back to us, and we have been negligent trying to do everything else without honor. Now, if we don't straighten this up, civilization on the planet is about to collapse. Meanwhile, nations, economies who got them treasury bonds that's been backing the U.S. corporations' debt since 1861 on our backs. It's like when you see in the Wizard of Oz, you see that house falling on the Wicked Witch's feet. And then you see the stockings curl up. The house, Zodiac, houses, comes down from the ethers.
Issues of the will.
And then the foundation goes on Dorothy's feet. That's the shoes. The red ruby jewels, red ruby slippers. You gotta understand the message. They're losing power. They're not the heirs. But Dorothy's still bumped in the head. She still don't know that she's home. She's trying to get home, and she's already home. She's always been home. So our people think that the black diaspora thing, they home. They never left home. They just been struck in the head. You understand the Wizard of Oz is they're telling you about you. Give her the mic.
The messed up thing about it is that whenever you, like, I'll try to tell people, because I'm Jamaican, as you can tell, so we're not very educated on these kind of things. So going to them and telling them, okay, read this letter from the Pope. And they'll literally sit there and read it, or actually sit there and read it. And then just go, okay. And I'm like, did you just see him call the president, acting president of Obama? Yeah. Okay, well, God made me this way, and I'm just gonna, you know.
Now, in law, see, that demonstrates incompetence. But what that person doesn't know, and this is not personal, they're about to be eliminated. I mean, like, for real, for real.
And we try to tell them, and they say, we're going to die anyway.
Well, again, this is divine law. This is divine law. It comes for the young yet unborn. Old can go if they want to. However, they take the side of Rome, they're going to discover it's not going to be the cakewalk that they think it's going to be by not taking responsibility. They don't have to turn their hearts back to their mothers and fathers. They're not required to. They're being offered the opportunity to. However, the real deal is what they're really saying is that Rome's my God. He gives me my widow moment slice. And I know what you're saying, but I don't care, because he's going to give me my sandwich. They don't know that Rome's getting ready to pull the legs from under the table. Not Rome, the Manchurians are pulling the legs from under the table. Rome ain't going to have control of them peanut butter sandwiches. And then when they turn around and then want to act like, oh, I'm apologizing, or I want to honor my mothers and fathers, I changed my mind, doors going to be closed. Because those are the spirits that sold our babies out before. They don't know. What Rome don't get, the two-edged sword going to get down. They don't make their choices now. See, this thing, like, let me tell you honestly. We can't stop the blood. Our job is to limit it. However, there's going to be a lot of blood. Now, that's the prophecy. And those who have an opportunity, willingly on their own, before the doo-doo, right now they're smelling farts. Later on, they're going to be really in the doo-doo, like for real, 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 real. Then, all of a sudden, they're going to be making solid decisions then. But at that time, they're going to stand the doo-doo.
Because we even tell them, okay, you don't have to believe this.
No, they no, that's why you got to give them references.
Store food. We travel, you know, I said to them something as simple as store food, we're storing food. And my brother-in-law go, yeah, you've always been crazy. And
now, let's look at this. Let's look at the reality. This is the job. And this is where you want to be fair. Mm-hmm. You want to be fair. You want to give them reference points so that you don't try to convince them on how you feel.
Yes, that's what we do.
See, because divine law requires you to give them absolute reference points. Mm-hmm. Because when you give them the reference points, then you step off. And you don't keep arguing with them.
Yeah.
This is so that you don't get smacked with the karmic. Because the area with the place that we're in now, you can call it a space, because there's not exactly a time the way we look at time. We're in a space now that when people are told the truth, you step off, the spirit step in. But that spirit got a sword. Mm-hmm. And that spirit's not going to take the mercy on them that you take on them. Mm-hmm. and the lessons are coming quicker now.
And the shelves are empty.
So you sincerely, sincerely tell them and give them the opportunity, but don't do it with arrogance. Don't do it with self-righteousness. Do it honestly and give them reference points so that they can do some research. And if they reject it, they're on their own. And don't feel sorry for them.
That's the hard part.
Because man is spirit and not the flesh. Mm-hmm. They're here for lessons. And if they choose not to bring remedy, they're going down with Rome. So don't be reaching your hand into that doo-doo pool with somebody who didn't want to come out the doo-doo pool, feeling all sorry for them. You know, this is where you get the story when it says two will be in the field, one will be taken, one will be left. Don't take it personal. In other words, there's enough BS going on right now and enough butt kicking going on right now that if our people don't understand that this man's not in their interest now, they never will. If he doesn't see what they're doing to our women, children, and men, etc., and they ain't figured it out yet, that's on them. Knock the dust off your heels, go tell somebody that wants to know, and keep it moving, and do not get personally attached. Get personally attached, you're gonna get damaged. Doesn't mean that you don't care. Don't misunderstand that. Mm-hmm. Doesn't mean you're not becoming hard-hearted, but don't get attached, because this is not a time for attachment. There's a storm going on, so don't be throwing a picnic blanket out thinking that you ain't gonna have soggy sandwiches. No picnic sandwiches. The picnic is over. So Mother Nature, this is what is happening right now, honest with you. We've been so tardy in our responsibility to ourselves and to our offspring that Mother Nature has taken it out of our hands. And this is where people make the mistake when they keep thinking that they have the power to do. It's not that you don't, so I don't want to kind of misword that. The actionable power is not allowed that men had, say, a decade or more ago, where a lot of things that shall take place, you had an opportunity or hand in it. Nature's kind of like pushing you aside and she's taking over. And you either on the right side, or you either on the front of the sword or you on the handle of the sword. And we can't play that two camps things too much anymore and get away with it. Nature is not allowing it.
There's no gray area.
Yeah, nature is not allowing it. So let's keep this in mind, Lincoln could not run for president for the Republic. They ran Lincoln for president of the Service Corporation. I'll be clear, you all.
Who was that?
Europeans. You gotta remember, Europeans being brought into government. This is what the Emirate felt in Granada. I'm giving you keys, and I'm gonna jump off because you weren't here earlier. The Emirate, the Red Palace, the Red House fell. That's 1492. The Vatican set up what is known as a global world trust that administers the great estate of the Moorish Empire. And so it is said, the sun never rises nor sets on the British Empire. It's really the Moorish Empire that Britain, under the secret treaty of Verona, is now controlling. You need to know the history.
I thought that was starting right after the French and Indian War.
Well, you gotta understand, yeah. With this statement, but it's talking about the fall of the Moorish government under now the control of England. What's the secret treaty? When you look at the three stars of Washington, D.C., right? The Vatican flag. Same flag George Washington's family used. Three stars. First star, what? Vatican. Sovereign city-state.
England.
District of London, sovereign city-state. Washington, D.C., sovereign city-state. The Trinity operations of the Spanish Inquisition for world conquest. That's your politics on planet Earth. Not to know that is dangerous. To be distracted from that reality, thinking that you know the history, is also dangerous because you're being distracted. If you don't understand that foundation, or somebody so-called helping our people whatever organizations they're talking about helping these people here, whatever brands they want to use, and they're not telling you this history, that's a COINTELPRO operation, guaranteed, because this is the foundation. Because you're not going to fix it if you don't understand the shadow government. How are you competent in any argument that you make? Except you keep calling them government when they're not, and you just assign them. You keep calling them officer and they're not, you just assign them. You're the heir. The administrator of the trust has to follow your instructions, even if you're stupid, to your disadvantage. And this is what they're doing. They're taking advantage of people who are colored. Our people think it means Afrocentric identity. Colored means artificial person. Distinguish from that which is real. They're totally incompetent. Then have their so-called paid-off leaders who keep convincing them that it's an Afrocentric identity and they believe them. Not knowing they're under control under the eugenics program. They are. And you can't tell them nothing because they got Allah and Jesus and Moses and, you know, God made them, didn't make nobody else, nobody else is saved but them. That's their attitude. And they're actually blinded to their own death that's pending. And the Europeans are going to try to kill them all because the guard is being changed on the ethereal plane. So it's out of their hands. So they're talking big stuff, but they're actually losing power, but they're gonna battle to the end. Meanwhile, they're gonna try to take a third of y'all down with them. And that's those who keep on believing them and keep on believing the programs that they keep presenting to you. Keep giving you this apple. This is a nice apple, why don't you bite it? It looks kind of shiny. You know, like when we was growing up, you know, like you go to the store and you used to get them candy apples?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
There was always the apples that had the spots on them. That's how they got rid of them.
That's true.
The worst ones. They would make the worst ones the candy apples.
Yeah, dip them in there. Yeah.
They make the worst ones the candy apples.
Yeah.
And I was,
you know, two steps from almost what happened.
Once I got
another one, they won't know good.
Touch
the
note.
Yeah. Anyway, so let's get back to the point because you got to really understand this. You got to understand this. And we've been over this, but I'm asking, as I asked earlier, because when the answers that you give tell me where you are. It tells me where you are. Now I'm going to try to go through this again. Keep notes. Keep notes. And you be a reporter. Keep me on point. All right? Because you gave a good answer. Lincoln, they ran Lincoln for president on this United States Corporation service company that had the contracts for the 19 enumerated powers for the legitimate United States government that was coming out of the Moorish government falling and bringing the Europeans in. This is why all your founding fathers had Korans. Are we clear? All right. Now, so now, out of this comes the United States Republic. Are we clear? So now, this will symbolize Casablanca or White House, all right? Symbolizing that, all right? All right? Excuse my scribble. So, Lincoln could not hold office in this United States, so they ran him for president in this United States that does the service contracts for this United States, are we clear? Because he was a member of the bar. Fatwa, he could not hold the office. Now, I'm going to tell you a scenario, and it's not a scenario, it's the absolute truth. Where you understand the politics. Lincoln got wind that they were using him to overthrow the Republic, and he tried to save the Union. Are we clear? May 10th of 1861, they fulfilled their plot to initiate a coup d'etat. Are we clear? The Congress for the United States, secretly fulfilling the secret treaty of Verona and continuing the Christian crusade operations, plotted and executed a coup d'etat. That coup d'etat is called in Reconstruction history as the Congress adjourning sine die. It's important for you to recognize what I'm just saying to you and put this in context. Are we clear? It is told you in Reconstructed history that the Congress for the United States, May 10 of 1861, adjourned sine die. It was really a coup d'etat. This is important for you to get that very clear. The shadow government begins. In honest, in earnest. Are we clear? Are we clear?
Clear.
So that's May 10, 1861. Now we're looking at a 10-year span, and we're going to talk about this 10-year span, all right? Sine die. Was really a coup d'etat. That's what really it was. Are we clear? In a 10-year span, they completed their in-house training for their membership to impersonate the offices while they really no longer held the offices. Are we clear? Are we clear?
Not clear.
That's called Act of Congress. That's February the 2nd. Are we clear? You see, that's roughly a 10-year span, give or take a month and a half or so. Are we clear? In that span between the coup d'etat and the Act of Congress, 1871, this was the perfecting of the political platform for the coup d'etat to smoothly operate, with everybody being trained to impersonate the offices that no longer existed in their authority at all. Are we clear? Are we clear? Shadow government. Are we?
Was this something that was done kind of like privately?
That's it. Now you're talking the public and private that you hear people talk about without really explaining the real history. They keep talking about debtor, creditor, and all that kind of stuff, and holder in due course, and there ain't no money type thing, and think they're going to get a taffy. This is the real history. If you don't understand the global trust, you have no claim. I don't care what the hell you do. That's why I'm telling you this history, because people keep on getting in these scenarios where people keep on selling their processes that represent a promise of attachment to the estate, and you ain't getting crap. It gives this man time. It must be collapsed. Do you understand? You're not getting anything from him. He's buying time to get you on a, he gets you on a treadmill. This, you know, anybody that knows this process operating with these Europeans, if you've been really studying, this is why we go back to the HMO, so I'm going to say, there's a this wealthy European named Emily Ford. She's come to the round table once in a while. She's a writer for the Higher Truth magazine. And as a matter of fact, interesting thing about it, that Chet picked me up the day earlier, and I hadn't seen him in a couple of years, and is actually at that house that I used to hold the classes with Brother Lean, who used to be a Scientologist, and I taught him, then he came out of that and he became Hajib for the round table. And he held classes there until he passed, forming 203. Emily Ford is a wealthy European woman and writer for Higher Truth magazine. And one of the sisters used to come to the class named Darlene. And Emily came there, she said, in this order. Are Europeans allowed to come to the round table? I mean, do you mind? You know, because I mean, because they use a lot of the so-called freedom European groups have always used some of our information. Anyway, they adjusted, but they've been doing it for years. And so Emily came to round table a few times. She actually shared a lot of information, right? One day, she asked me about what my thoughts were about some of the European so-called sovereignty groups, etc. And at sometimes with some of their groups, they were talking white Christian sovereign, and these are some of the demonstrations they were using. And there was another European that was doing classes named Phil Marsh, I think it was Phil Marsh or something like that. They were like charging like 1,500, 1,600 classes. You know, we was giving classes free, you know, to people. And they was charging 1,500 for classes for this information. But one thing I said to Emily, I asked her, I said, what's your nationality? And she said, I'm American white, right? And I said, what's your mother's nationality? And she said, her mother's German, and I forget, I apologize, so I don't want to lie. I forget what she said her father was. I said, well, in truth is, who your mother is, that's who you are. And I said, you're not white, you're not American. The problem that they're having, I was making reference to the so-called white sovereignty groups, because what happens, because the Europeans have had access to knowledge that our people haven't had, because they already know this. Most of them are Masons, Eastern Stars, Skull and Bones, Kuiklos, Ku Klux Klan, Knights Templars. So this information is common to them. It wasn't common with our people. Do you understand? And so since the Europeans, middle class, have been slowly dissolving, they already know by projection that the time was coming, so they would start preparing earlier, meaning that they know how government really operates. Let me say it like this. This is how government operates. Like say, for instance, right now, we're doing some things. You're Sayaraha. I'm getting ready to go to California this Tuesday, right? Just in the order of business, no different than we're going next door to get some juice or something like this. I'm going to California, and it wouldn't even be the discussion. You'd already do a chart. And then tell me whether to change the date, make adjustments, go fly from a certain place or not fly, or go with certain people or some people that was going, they're not going with you. It'll be changed like that, and I wouldn't argue. That's how things are run, because I know you're dealing with the star charts. That's how civilization runs. It always did. The only people who don't know that is our people who fell from it and started following after the idol gods of Rome, and this is where our whole fall is. So the rest of the world still operating on civilization. We operate on dogma, keep losing, and of course the devil did it, didn't it? And this is really what's wrong with us. Do you understand what I'm saying to you? But anyway, you simply do a chart, and then the chart would, I'll make adjustments accordingly. We wouldn't even argue. I just double check it on the chart, and it's how it rolled, and that would be going with whoever. That's it. Every day it operates that way. That's how government runs. It doesn't run on beliefs. It runs on mathematics. Star charting. The wise men follow the stars. The dummies follow the priest. He always gets their cookies. But I'm going to get back to this. So you want? No, I'm telling you the honest truth. So, Lincoln, keep in mind, between May the 10th and February the 2nd, they set up the Bureau, write this down, this is the proper name, Bureau of Refugees, Freedmen, and Abandoned Lands. That's the proper name of what you've been falsely told in history is the Freedmen's Bureau.
Bureau of Refugees and Freedmen's
Bureau of Refugees, Freedmen, and Abandoned Lands. Pay attention, whenever you see any foreclosure operating under this United States Corporation Company, it will be listed in the counties or in your local governments as abandonments. You need to know that you're dealing with the state. I'm telling you these things because you're going to have to add the rest of the information, meaning that I'm giving you markers and expecting you to expand. All right? At the same time, it will answer a lot of questions that you didn't ask. Are we clear? Now, between this, remember they did the Emancipation Proclamation and they modified it three different times before it was issued. This would include what led to the establishment of the Bureau of Refugees. The refugees are our people. Refugees on your own land. This is what Martin Luther King, 33 Degree Mason, was talking about. Our people, refugees on their own land. You ain't come from nowhere else, you guys. Set up the Freedmen's Bureau. With the Freedmen's Bureau, you're supposed to be giving back your name, your nationality. You're supposed to be giving back the culture of Islam, etc., science, etc. And you're supposed to be giving every man, woman, and child minimally, and in some cases more, but minimally 40 acres and a mule and a house, meaning that a house, you could design the house, so finance to support it, and for whatever venture that you want to do would be financed. Of course, Freedmen's Bureau was opened approximately 65 to 68, roughly 3 years. They squandered the finance with the intentions of closing it, which they did. So they opened the Freedmen's Bureau in 1865, and closed 1868. Then they created what is known as the dead man, the corpse, the man of straw, the transmitting utility for the Global World Trust that was set up when the Emirate fell. It's called the 14th Amendment Corporate Entity Person. And then they gave it the name of a monkey. And so they needed the people to agree to be monkeys so that they could take them out of the human family and say they volunteered it. So they said, if y'all want to be citizens, you got to be Negroes. And so, and then they got the, like Dr. Nyland was saying, your local Negro clergy guys, to convince them to be people of color and Negroes and blacks, and tell them it meant African, and they could be citizens. They were really agreeing to be animal stock. Because Negro is a monkey, not a human. Negro comes from Negro Yabera Arebo, which is black chimpanzee monkey. So Charles Darwin talks about it. And then they agreed to be Negroes, and then they thought they could be citizens of the United States. They were stock, and then they were registered on 55 Water Street in New York, put on the stock market to back all the United States debt here. Now, let me tell you about this debt. You know how everybody keeps saying, y'all got contracts out there, y'all got debts out there, and all that kind of stuff. They're full of crap. It's a lie. when Lincoln recognized that they were using him to undermine the Republic, because they had the service contracts, he deliberately bankrupted that United States and France. Are we clear? Are we clear? Please say it. Lincoln bankrupted that United States service company in France that was founded in 1754 by Benjamin Franklin, who was later, or was already being prepared as a minister plenipotentiary with the treaty. Are we clear?
Yes.
All right.
Clear.
There's three other things that Lincoln did that put a target on his back. He did two major cases that they will publish, and you'll have to dig. You're not going to find this in your regular school book, but you'll find this in any quality library, where Lincoln did two cases making the distinction between Negroes, blacks, and Moors being the same people, same blood, different status. Are we clear?
Clear.
Which is a counteraction to the secret treaty of Verona operations that was afoot. Because the overthrow of the Republic is an overthrow of the Moorish government and the treaty. Because the treaty and the Constitution are one document. To overthrow the Constitution is to overthrow the treaty. They're one and the same. That's why they don't teach you treaty law and Constitution as if it's one, when it absolutely is. Keep this in mind so that your head will be right. Particularly this baby girl. All debts contracted and entered into before the adoption of this Constitution shall be binding against the United States under this Constitution as under the Confederation, and all treaties made or which shall be made under the authority thereof shall be the supreme law of the land. How many of our people know that the treaty is supreme law of the land, or even talk about it? They not only don't know it, they don't talk about it, and their concepts are wrong. They keep looking for some other processes to do that the European keeps offering them instead of enforcing the contract, which is the will. They are national wills. They're equity contracts. That's what binds them, nothing else. And we keep on buying into other games they keep presenting, which gives him time. And the BS continues. Now, as generations have passed, now it's up to you, basically now. You have no knowledge of this whatsoever because the adults before you sold you out with their daggone beliefs, adopting all their belief systems that don't mean a damn thing except mind control. Do you understand? Which is why you're here, which is why I want to make sure that you get this. Do you understand? You're the heirs to the world's largest estate and don't know it. Your poverty is absolutely, absolutely artificial. You're the wealthiest people on the planet. You don't have any business being poor. You have no business being in need. Your mental is wrong. Our mental is wrong. Our concept of history is wrong. Our concept of law is wrong. Our concept of person is wrong. All these things must be corrected because you're not going to always be getting this information. And if you don't get this stuff grounded, they're going to try to eliminate you before you do get it grounded. And they're accelerating their activities to do so that extend behind the chem clouds and the GMOs. They're trying to get more and more direct. The only thing that's stopping a lot of stuff that they already planned is the Manchurians. If one for the Manchurians, would be a lot more of our people dead already. With the help of Russia. And that's the real truth. Our people really do not understand the politics on this planet.
No.
Anyway, so keep this in mind and keep this understanding so you can understand the politics. So when Lincoln recognized that they were undermining the Republic and using him to do it, he bankrupted that United States. So that United States is bankrupt. The shadow government begins because the plot begins in England with the mayor, the exequaturs, etc., to convert that debt of that bankrupt United States Corporation Company on the descendants of the Moors, who they tagged as African Americans. That's the whole fraud, that's all of it. That's the debt that everybody keeps talking about. The debt is that United States Corporation Company in France that Lincoln bankrupted. The revenge is to convert that debt onto the backs of the descendants of the world's estate, the Moors, and use them, make bonds to back that United States debt since the Civil War. Are we clear? Now we're going to go through a scenario, then you get involved. That United States existed up until 19 and 13. Now, when you go into congressional records, you will notice that all property was held by aboriginal title or allodial title until 1913 with Woodrow Wilson, who was one of your big Knights of Columbus, Ku Klux Klan operatives to counter Noble Draw Lee, who set up the old Canaanite temple for the restoration of the estate and the enforcement of these equity contracts back to the proper heirs. That's why the issue of you not being Negro, Black, and colored is emphasized since 1913. Mm-hmm. That's when he met with the Jesuits off Jekyll Island. Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. Change faces. Shadow government. Then all of the allodial titles were converted into dead pledges. The contract was dead and you was the pledge. It is called mortgage. Mortgage. That's when they began. 1913. Congressional records for anybody who wants to know. Then, with the plot to convert this debt onto the descendants of the estate, i.e. the Moors. In order to create, this is why when you go into the congressional records, they created a double stock trust and disallowed anybody else from doing it. So they could track and be the beneficiary and the trustee at the same time, which collapses a trust under ordinary condition. You cannot be the administrator or the trustee and the beneficiary in any trust estate. Can't happen. So they created a double stock trust, shadow government. Now, Noble Draw Lee came along, 1913, set up Old Canaanite Temple for the restoration of the estate and for all this history to be told and for the state to be restored to its proper heirs. So the Queen of England said, well, yeah, he is the noble and we are obligated, and this is why they start calling him Noble Draw Lee. Are we clear? Set up the old Canaanite temple. It ran for a while, developing the people, coming from all walks of life. Then he set up the Moorish Temple of Science, sometimes called Moorish Holy Temple of Science, and registered it as a civic organization to teach government with the help and the support of Marcus Garvey. Are we clear? Who taught government?
Clear.
And Draw Lee taught nationality. 1925, 1926. Woodrow Wilson instructed him to take the flag out of the vault. They took the flag out of the vault, the star was out. Draw Lee told him to put the star back in. Woodrow Wilson told Noble Draw Lee, he said, to give these niggers back Islam will be like putting a pair of pants on a horse. However, if you can get 500 to follow you, I'll back you with my Army and Navy. That's Calvin Coolidge, President for the United States, to draw in. Of course, it went into the millions very quickly. COINTELPRO operations began. 1929, Noble Jolly was assassinated. Between 1930 and 1934, you got a whole bevy of so-called black groups that was funded from what is called the Great Sellout. Do you research, I don't even want to name it. This is where you have the split. And then all of a sudden you got Temple of Islam, Sweet Daddy Grace, Father Divine, Bishop Johnson, Bishop Cherry, whole crew of them, all between 1930 and 34. Well funded. And then convinced the people to be black again. The only one kept the peace signal was Daddy Grace, peace. No, that's Father Divine, peace.
Yeah.
Daddy Grace kept the crescent and the star, and then two lions on the House of Prayer. Because he put the crescent and the star at the top. And he wore his fez and jalabu for a few years early, then after all, they stopped that. Pretty much the rest of them took the people back into the black game. So now it's called sellout. Now he's got the stagnation. This is the information in the area that Malcolm found out. This is also when they couldn't buy him off, why they murdered him. And of course, anybody who knows Khalid, as soon as he started telling these people their Moors a couple years ago, then all of a sudden he had a seizure.
I was told that prior to the assassination or slash maybe ascension of Noble Ali, that there had been a conference in Cuba.
Yes.
And he presented the proof.
Yeah, the mandate. It's called the mandate.
Okay.
You know, and so what you actually had was all the true American states, because we've got to remember America's are states. The people here who don't know geography, because they're not taught geography, they think Delaware, New Jersey, Pennsylvania, that's their mentality. In the real world government, the states are the nations. Brazil, Mexico, Dominica, these are the American states. Are we clear? Now, the people here aren't taught, so they don't know that. So all of the American states, that's why it's called the Pan-American Conference. Because the American Conference is really the African Conference.
Well, he had the land deeds or something.
Yes. See, because the United States was over. They had a mandate. It's over. So they had to get them out of the way. Now, pay attention to this. 1913, Jolly set up the Old Canaanite Temple for the restoration of the estate. That United States that they created there, they created that shell, it collapsed. 1913. They set up the extra church chamber. Remember, hell is not a place to go. Hell is the church prison. We need the expiatory chamber for those who wouldn't pay tithe. It's called Roman tax. That expiatory chamber became the Inquisition Revenue Services, which is now called Internal Revenue Services, set up between 1913 and 1916, and the Federal Reserve, and was registered in Puerto Rico as another shell United States. So now you have another United States shell. 1913. To continue the fraud of converting that debt from 1754 that Lincoln bankrupted, they set up a new shell corporation, United States Corporation Company, registered in Puerto Rico, to continue this fraud. This is the debt that everybody keeps talking about and won't tell you its origin. Keep telling you, you owe this. You don't owe crap. It's put on you under a color of law. It is not your debt. It is the debt of that United States Corporation Company in France that was bankrupted by Abraham Lincoln. The revenge was kill Lincoln and put the debt on you. That's why they created the 14th Amendment, to take you out of the human family. Then they put their family names on you in order that whatever you buy or sell with the mark or the number of that name is automatically state property. They even made a clothing line that they call state property. A lot of people walk around proudly, don't even know it's a step of their birthright. So you, not only do they not know history, they're spiritually dead. Islam, go ahead.
How do you spell exiture?
Exiture? Like check, you know, like you have a check. E-X, check. With a Q-U-E-R, exiture. So the IRS is really the exiture's office. This is why they can make up arbitrary things and just take your finance and take stuff, because they're taking it under Inquisition operations. Why do you think that there's no what you would call solid measuring point? And why do you think they convert your labor into income when income only applies to corporate entities? That's why I did that book years ago, Confused About Taxes, just to keep the basic, simple concept to the average person if they ever have fraud the IRS. They need to know the law. You don't have income. Corporations have income. Confused About Taxes. And I'll make, you know, law of reference points and show you their own stuff. These people don't know that when they're so-called paying income taxes, that they're actually doing expiture chambers payments. They're in hell. That's hell.
Oh, I'm sorry.
You don't think so? Look in the dictionary. Look up hell.
I'm sorry.
In dictionary. Hell Black's Law Dictionary, 4th edition, deluxe, ancient and modern history. I mean, ancient and modern jurisprudence.
Okay.
Great, sis.
Hell. The name formerly given to a place under the exchequer chamber, where the king's debtors were confined, rich debt.
So as you can see, people now, the clergy have been telling people that hell's down below with the red devil.
Fire and brimstone.
And it's beneath the exeture's chamber of the church.
Wow.
For those who didn't pay the taxes and the tithe. See why they don't have law books in our communities, and our people keep talking about they know Jesus, they know Allah and Muhammad and Buddha. They don't even know what's in front of their damn faces.
Clear.
See why the Bible says, how dare you claim the love of God you do not see, and love not your brothers and sisters whom you see every day? Likewise, how dare you claim a knowledge of the nether world and know not what stands before your face? It's not only hypocrisy, it's a lie. So you have to rescue the children. Because they're under dogma of thinking they got religion, and they're being played by the clergy themselves.
Yeah.
Now you understand why they have a skull and bones agreement? They're kickback and make people thinking that that's Jesus' head. With no conscience, ameliorating their own interest. Why do you think they won't let people see their secret oath to the Pope? It's in the congressional records, it's not hidden. And that's not really not, because all of them is not really like bad people. They're getting the people what they want. People want to, so it's sort of like, the rationale is this. They take advantage of the people with limited conscience because the people are considered dead in law anyway. And since they dishonored their mothers and fathers, they don't have to feel guilty for screwing them. Because that's how they lost their estate, because they honored not their mothers and their fathers. Do you understand? Now, so keep this in mind. So 1913, this United States collapsed. So they set up another one and registered it in France. Are we clear?
Yes.
Are we clear?
Yes.
Another United States shell.
Puerto Rico.
Pardon me, I apologize. So now they set up another United States corporation company in Puerto Rico. That runs until June the 5th of 1933. They got rid of no draw leave July the 29th. In July of 1929. A couple years later, that United States collapses. Are we clear? So now they create another United States shell. To keep this fraud going on, keep in mind this is a series of successions. Now I'm not going to write this down, I expect you to write this down. Franklin Delano Roosevelt, Skull and Bones, set up another United States corporation company shell to complete this fraud, descendancy. This is called corporate secession. Corporate secession. Are we clear? So now we've got another United States shell to convert this debt of this United States of 1754 that Abraham Lincoln bankrupted when they recognized they were using him to undermine the legitimate republic. Are we clear?
Clear.
All right, that's when the greenback thing comes in, going back to the Constitution, because they were undermining it. That's one of the reasons that he got murdered. Are we clear? Amongst other stuff.
Your phone's battery is getting low.
This United States Corporation Company lasts to this year, May the 2nd, something like that.
Yes.
May the 2nd, 2016, they will tell you that Puerto Rico went bankrupt. What they're telling you that United States shell went bankrupt.
Again.
They start setting it up again. Manchurians, and Russians told them no more shells. No more shell corporations. No more conversion of this debt onto the heirs of the estate, i.e. the Moors. And they start dumping all around the world in a controlled state all U.S. T-bonds that began from the time of the Civil War that has been backing that false debt that don't really belong to us. That's what's going on in the world. Are we clear? If you understand this history, you will understand why Noble Drolley said continuously, if you don't do anything else, declare your nationality. Why? You're the heirs to this estate, and all of these bonds have been placed against your estate without your knowledge, and the transmitting utility, or that straw man, was created for them to go in and out of that Sister QV trust. They have set up in 1666, Sester Q, V Act. And that's the pattern they use. This is one of the church bullets. That's the pattern they use for the 14th Amendment in 1868 when they closed the Freedmen's Bureau to set up the dead and declared you civil litermortuus. Dead at sea until proven otherwise.
Wow.
And so all transactions in relationship to all economics concerning you, including your labor, including all inheritances, all hereditaments, corporal and incorporal, is state property, not yours. You're declared dead, it's declared abandoned, and they have claimed it, and they've been backing that corporate debt that has accrued over this century on you. That's the debt. You're not the debt. Are we clear?
Clear.
So when people keep telling you, you got debts up there, they're lying. They're trying to convert that United States, which has been the basis of the entire politics since May Since May the 10th of 1861 and the shadow government began. That shadow government is called the U.S. Demon Democracy. That's the shadow government. That's what's been, that's de facto, that's what's been in operation, distinguished from the Republic, which is you, and silent. Are we clear? Yeah, now, you understand your answer earlier?
Clear.
Good. That should put a little bit more clarity on it, should it?
Yes.
All right, now you perfect that, teach it to your friends. And this is the deal, is the youth got to get it because they've got to take this to the next generation because the elders have been sellouts. They've been compromised. They keep looking for, as soon as this man come up with another red taffy, they run trying to bite him. And then the things that should be told to you, they go undone. Then you're declared incompetent and that gives this man more time. This is why the Russians and the Manchurians had to step in. Because we've just become too compromised, we're too hypocritical. We'll sell our babies out. And so the brothers and sisters have to come from the east, even into the west, to aid the redemption of the lost sheep. Because they just refuse to honor their mothers and fathers. However, they're given a chance to turn their hearts back to their mothers and fathers. This is where you get your locked in of the four chapters in the book of Malachi, where the code of the zodiac is given to you, codified. Son of righteousness rises with healing in his wings, is spelled S-U-N. And that lets you turn your hearts back, that the earth will smitten with a curse, is why you're getting these chemtrails and all this other stuff. They're going to kill you off. You can decide whether you want to fix this thing, and no one's going to fix it for you. So don't get this idea that somebody's going to set up some program for you, because it ain't going to happen. It's going to come from you, and it's going to come from your heart. You decide you don't want it, it's no problem. However, you ain't going to be here either. And you ain't going to get no cookies. You know, these people keep thinking they're going to get this package without, you know, their brothers and sisters. You know, I got this process. I'm going to get this, and I'm either going to sell it to my brothers and sisters, or I ain't going to tell them, and I'm going to, you know, you are your brother's keeper, and you ain't getting it. If you want it, tell somebody who don't know. Seek for them what you seek for yourself. And that's the only way the cosmic brother recognizes you. And you better do it sincerely.
Oh, yes.
And do it because it's right, not because you want a package. Not because you want a cookie. And that's how it works. Now, do you understand the shell game? Now, the Manchurian set upon the planet a couple years ago, and it's active as we speak, over 6.5 million perfected assassins as a countermeasure to European colonial operations on Earth planet, sometimes called Gaia. There's counter moves, and this one's been lost on both sides. However, the Romans are not going to outlast them, because there's also 20 million more in the wings. So negotiations are going on as we speak. And that's the real politics that's taking place. You've been given this information for a few years. You should have been putting some of it to work to help yourself and to help your families. If you haven't perfected it yourself logically, you won't be able to transmit it to someone else. That's why I'm giving you these keys so that you don't have to be confused on how to convey this information. It has to become your own. And you have to transmit it to another. In other words, your taffy is in the hand of another. Your raincoat is in the hand of another. Put the raincoat on them in order for you not to get wet. And your sincerity is how, and keep this in mind, this is really true. The little games that we've been used to playing with the politics, you know, throwing things around, manipulating things politically, it ain't working now. So don't get that idea. That's not how things are operating now. In the Aquarian constellation, you gotta remember Uranus and Saturn is ruling now. Together. with Uranus electrifying everything. Everything in every body, in every institution, is charged to prove itself. It's charged to prove itself. Whatever you claim, you ain't got proof to me, and I don't have to prove anything to you. You're going to prove it, and you're going to be charged to prove it, and nature is the measure now. The Tao, that's Tao, T-A-U, of nature, is measuring you. And she does not recognize person or station. So take your belief systems, dump it in that basket. And take your emotions, sit on them. And when they get flat, remove them from your pocket and throw them in the trash basket. And get real. Because she is not playing. You've had more than enough time. More than enough time. And there's no need for you, when I say you, I'm talking plural, which includes myself. Keep making excuses. And so, the Europeans, or what you call the Romans, a lot of things that you see happening all over the place, if you see anything unusual happening that's destructive, 99% of them are false flags. You understand? They're getting desperate. You understand? So if you think for 2 minutes that your welfare is secure in their hands, I suggest do not hold your breath. This is what I suggest that you do. Everything that you possess now, if you have any possessions, put it in a trust. You're going to be killing those bonds that attach to that name that's related to you, that's an XREL, but not you. Go ahead, give him a mic.
Turn the mic on. The World Trust.
Turn the mic on.
Thank you so much. It was on.
I like this chair.
Go ahead.
Hello. The World Trust, the Global World Trust. Is that a 501c3 cult thing?
No, that's superior to all of them. Listen. All right. Even though it is morally and ethically colored, it is the supreme political estate operations on Earth planet. It does not come under the Exeter's chamber. The Exeter's chamber comes under it. It's sort of like this. When you're talking about the Global World Trust, it is not restricted as the subordinate corporate entities are. It, those things are not required of it.
Now, the reason why I'm asking is because I got a call this week and after the last 2 years, a bunch of us have set up our own trust for studying and using common law trust. Well, there was one guy, I'm not mentioning any names, he set up a 501c4 trust versus a 501c3 trust.
Yeah.
I'm confused. I'm like, wait a minute, hold up here.
No, you're not confused.
No,
this is what has happened. Let's, before you go further, I'm going to tell you exactly what's happened. There's been enough information out. Just think this out. Think this out. And go back to your mind. Accept what he said, then go back to your mind. There's been enough information out for a while that people are starting to catch on that the 501c3 is a compromise instrument for control purposes. So the Europeans issue a 501c4 to make them think they got a better taffy. Listen to this. Clearfield Trust Company. How many of you are familiar with Clearfield Trust Company? Y'all are putting your hand down too slow, too fast. Put your hand up and look around, y'all. Clearfield Trust Company. Why did the Clearfield Trust Company fight that $20 and 24 cent stolen check that cost them like multiple thousands with court operations. Why did they fight it, and why did they win the case? Answer it. After you answer, then somebody else raise their hand.
The government acted as a business. Yeah. And so it put it into...
Now, come back again. Okay. Say it slow. Let's talk principle.
Yeah.
Well, whenever there's standard sites of res judicata in Supreme Court, there's a principle on which the case is rendered. Meaning there's a principle upon which the decision is rendered. Talk the principle upon which that decision was rendered. You know it, but this is what I'm appealing to, because this is really I'm talking to everybody. We want to get out of describing or estimating things, and we need to be specific on cause and effect, because that's when we become effective in law in any legal argument. Now, hint, Dr. Naima, is hint. It's right there on the board. It's what we've been talking about. You may not see it written in the case, but if you don't know what it's based in, they can talk you into another jurisdiction while you're trying to argue a principle. You're making a partial argument.
A private corporation.
It was a shadow government.
Here's where the shadow government is where...
was acting in the form of a business and was charging, and the trust argued that he didn't have to pay that.
Yes. Now, listen to your argument. You're not wrong. But your answer can be defeated. Listen. Clearfield Trust. What is the issue of the Clearfield Trust? The issue of the Clearfield Trust is that this false debt is artificially placed on African Americans who are tagged as blacks under their code operations, i.e. their Christian black codes. They're saying, y'all pulled that stuff on the niggers. You know damn well it ain't for us. And on principle, we're not going for it. Because you know, and we know, that you're not government. You're no different than McDonald's. Going, coming around, sending Ronald McDonald, come tell us about some debt or what you're going to do because of this check that was bounced and blah, 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 blah. You ain't government, and you don't have the authority, and we ain't having it. How about that, U.S. corporation, government registered in Puerto Rico, that ain't government, imposters? De facto, you got no authority. Now you go play that nigger game with these dummies that keep thinking you God and white man. They keep calling you white man, so you're their sovereign. You ain't our sovereign. Go over there, watch them call you white man. Yeah, you were their God. Don't pull that on us. I'm telling you, basically, that's the case. Then all you need to do is go amongst our people, and the first thing gonna come out their mouth, white man. Just call him sovereign ruler of the land, they get pissed when he acts like it. And then meanwhile, they talk about how spiritual they are and that they know law. I suggest they don't know crap, and they're full of crap, and they need to stop selling their babies out. But nobody won't tell them to their face because they, you know, they sensitive and all that stuff and whatever games they want to play. They keep selling the next generation out. Clearfield Trust Company wasn't having it. Now, as far as the 501c3 and C4, right? You got subordinate foreign corporate entity called Inquisition Revenue Services, called the IRS, that's also registered in Puerto Rico, that's commanding a hell tax on these people who think that their labor is income under the dead corpse because they can't damn read. Meanwhile, they talking about their spiritual and everything like this, and Clearfield Trust Company saying, we ain't your monkey. That's the monkey nigga tax. Don't play with us. We're going to fight you on principle. The principle is the coup d'etat. Since the coup d'etat of 1861, there was no lawful government here. They're in anarchy. The Civil War has not been resolved. Now, you've been going along with this thing, everybody been making some finance off the dummies who don't know is their estate. But you ain't coming at us on this. We ain't having it. It's on a principle. Do you understand what they're saying to you? What the Clearfield Trust representative is saying, you ain't pulling this nigger hell tax on us for that $20.24 check that was bounced, that was stolen, on principle. And that's the principle. This is why people who really understand the Clearfield can use it in foreclosure cases if they know the real argument. This is why we tell you use Clearfield, but not because the case itself can be used, because you need to know what's really the principle behind it. You don't need it, it's just a reference. You need to know the principle behind it. You're not talking to government. You're talking to a foreign corporate imposter that keeps putting burdens on you and you keep giving them jurisdiction. So again, tell me about this 501c3 4 5 6 7 8 or whatever else one they want to hand you to keep getting you to voluntarily give them jurisdiction.
Meaning that if
we would use our common sense, this is back to the point. And this is back to the babies. This is, you know, why I'm emphasizing this. And even when you're talking, I say, make sure baby girl understands it. It's because you have to understand the principle behind it. If you understand the principle, you don't need the case. The case is only a reference point. You need to know the principle. The principle is that they are not government. How? Now, look. At what point in jurisprudence do you derive a de jure action out of a de facto platform?
Can.
Is it possible to get de jure out of color?
No.
Possible.
Whether it's a 501c3, 501c4, 501c3 and a half with four quarters. Do you understand it's the principle? That the people, upon waking up, look at this. Now, this is what's happening.
It's real clear, and you know something? Because they had mentioned they used biblical scripture to entice people, it got me thinking about this global trust they're doing. So actually, this guy is really just another one that's creating problems.
What you have is this. As the people are developing, and they can't ignore things anymore because people are losing their accounts, they're losing all forms of the artificial, that little cartoon, Lucy, where Charlie, the guy, Lemuel, he has his blanket with flies on it, and he walks around with his blanket, he won't release it. He's not handicapped, but he's handicapped. So that blanket is his security. The psychology that we suffer from is all of these programs that were set up since then to make these people think they were being secured when they were actually voluntarily selling themselves out. Once they've extracted enough, now they're going to kill you off. They have no intentions of satisfying any of these things. Their mission was to rob you. It always was, it always is. Now, just like the spider, that your carcass is almost dry, they intend to drop you on the pile beneath the web. at what point you don't get it. And they keep inviting you, and you keep going, oh, Black Widow Spider-Man's pretty good, man, I was checking her out, man. Don't go kissing her. You're the next meal. You want a date? Oh, I think so. I'm cool. I got, yeah. I appeal to your intelligence, because you are intelligent, and you're a thinker, and you're a critical thinker. As we talk, and we've talked before, a lot of things I look at, you know what you hear me always saying, I don't tell people not to do things. I tell them to look at things. Anything that you do that starts upsetting the system, I'm for. But I also say, don't put all your cookies in that basket, because you need to know that you're on a learning curve. But if you think you're going to get something from them, you're just giving them time, because they're not going to give you anything. They're going to deceive you, keep you busy, then devour you and drop you. They even tell you in King Alfred. What do they tell you in the executive order 11490? We will encroach upon their rights. They will adjust. Then we'll keep on encroaching. Then we will do what? Attack all of their vital social energies. Suck their essence. Devour them. Then separate from this parent.
What a bad part is that?
Well, they didn't hide it. They always tell you. Is it not true? That the demons always tell you that what they're going to do to you and then do it? To save themselves from the karmic debt, because they know divine law cannot be bridged without consequence. Therefore, their practice is arc deception. So they tell you, well, what we want to do is kick his thine ass, put your ear on the other side, then summarily extend you from the ceiling. Translation, hang your butt. And you read it, and then they do it, and you act like you're surprised. Back to point. Let's keep it simple. And you know, when I say, you know, for a baby girl to understand, if they were colored with the 501c3, which was set up, what? Now let's look at this. Let's look at the facts. Is it not true that John Kennedy abridged the secret treaty of Verona by trying to duplicate part of what Lincoln did?
Yes.
And to reinstitute the Gold Act, which was abrogated March or May the 10th of 61,
yes,
which was part of the mission of the Inquisition operation to overthrow the Republic.
Yes.
And wasn't Kennedy's secretary named Lincoln?
Yes.
And wasn't Lincoln's secretary named Kennedy?
Yes. Yes.
Yes.
Yes.
And wasn't the year or 60 both of them assassinated?
Yes. Yes.
Everything they deal with mathematics. Mm-hmm. They tell you they're going to do it, and you keep buying it. Mm-hmm. At what point are we really going to demonstrate that we have any spiritual insight? How does this European keep getting these people back into these traps? He keep making them offers, and they keep buying it.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Well, see, that apple, I know it had 5 worms in it, so we're going to give you a new apple. Now, instead of candy red, this is a little bit more burgundy. 501c4. And they keep falling for this stuff. They had no jurisdiction there, and they have no jurisdiction now. Do me this favor. Pull up the post letter on your phone.
Oh, I'm
going to
have batteries to plug in.
pull post letter on your phone and get the mic and then read that. Now, I want you to read the last few paragraphs. Give her the mic, too. Make sure she has the mic. You hold the mic for her while she reads.
Obama?
Yeah, the letter to Obama. The last three paragraphs. Read the part where we talk about the estates. The estates, all estates.
Okay, all those estates.
Yes. Now, make sure you're in the mic. Now, listen to this carefully, you all, and analyze this.
All those estates and estates, in all caps, erroneously believed to represent the American states and American state citizens, and which were conveyed by fraud and legal deceit to the United States of America, minor, and more recently to the city-state of the United Nations, are revenued without exception to the geographically defined American states and the American state citizens, where they shall remain in perpetuity.
So now that's the Pope, and he owns all the corporate entities on Gaia, on Earth, right? Is there some encumbrance that you gotta jump through to reclaim your estate? Is there some debt or some process that you must fill or you fail? Is there some IRS form that you're required to fill for the restoration of your estate? Is there some encumbrance that's implied? Is it free and clear? So now, here's the Pope. He owns all the corporate entities that these people keep on going to look for permission to reclaim some aspect of their estate. What does that indicate to you? They're incompetent, they continue to be incompetent, and they keep giving this man jurisdiction, and then they keep running all around, getting apostilles, sealing this, sealing that, going here, going there, and your estate's been relinquished back to you without encumbrance. So we have to save the babies. Because they're going to kill the rest of them off. Because they're just damn hard-headed. They keep selling out the next generation. They keep looking for taffy. As soon as the man offers them here's a lollipop. Keep the wrapper on and don't try to get to the other corner because you're going to lose weight quickly.
That's what happened to me.
I'm appealing to the intelligence. Stop jumping through hoops. Understand that birthright, unalienable rights. Baby girl, go on the law dictionary and look at unalienable rights. Liens placed upon you. Because remember, the liens are from this debt under that U.S. corporate entity that was killed by Lincoln that they've been constantly converting on you. This is where the Pope is telling you this fraud began 150 years ago. He's giving you a rounded number. Do you understand? That's this dead corporate debt that they keep converting on you. Go ahead. Make sure you're in the mic. Get in the mic, Mom. Unalienable, yeah.
The house?
And capable of being aligned. That is sold and transferred.
Unalienable. Inalienable. Incapable of being aligned. That is sold and transferred.
Alright, so now a birthright is an unalienable right. How is it that people keep coming up these processes that you've got to file these papers with any corporate entity and go get anything stamped or apostilled any damn where in order to claim a right that is in its first instance unalienable, unless you keep giving up your birthright. Which keeps giving this man a mandate, then you keep starting all these nigger groups to try to get your rights back. And your actions keep indicating that you're incompetent. That's what I'm showing you this. Do you understand that, doctor? This is where the packages sales come in, where it's a fraud, where people keep on, they're using half of this knowledge. They studied well, then they got something to sell that's really unalienable. The debt belongs to that corporate entity. It doesn't belong to you. Now, I want you to read the rest of the post letter, and then we'll answer a few questions and close out. Because we're keeping Dr. Nayel up. And also, keep in mind, you all, for those of you pass the word around, because things aren't what they used to be. So if you got any spare change, make sure you send it down to Dr. Nayela to keep this house open. It's 602 Vandegrift. All right? So pass it around. Go ahead.
What? The American state citizens, where they shall remain in perpetuity as assets belonging to the rightful and lawful beneficiaries.
So now we're talking the state, aren't we? Huh? All right, so we ain't talking privileges, are we? All right, continue to read. Now read it totally out. Read it totally out.
All legal fiction entities, however, structured and named after the American states and American state citizens, are returned to them and their control, free and clear of any debt, promise, encumbrance, or obligation alleged against them as a result of false claims made in their behalf by officers of the United States of America, Incorporated, and the United States, Inc., or by any foreign officials operating the United States of America Minor, or the United Nations City-State, falsely claiming to represent them or have jurisdiction over them. We note that the current circumstance is in part the result of criminal acts engaged in 150 years ago, which resulted in the commercial enslavement of African Americans who were summarily claimed as chattels back in U.S. government debt in the wake of the Civil War. Despite every act of abolition and declaration of prohibition against both peonage and slavery, it has been the policy of the U.S. government to enslave its citizens and to operate as a rogue state among the nations of the world. Instead of freeing African Americans, the sum total result of the Civil War was to vastly expand public sector ownership of slaves, giving rise to the outrageous and improper claims that have been made against the American states and the American state citizens that we are dealing with today. It is uniquely fitting that the Grand Army of the Republic is recalled to settle the circumstance in favor of the people.
Yeah, read on. Keep on reading on. Read the attachments.
Yeah. Attachments. Attachments. Civil orders. Anna Maria Wilhelmina. Hannah Sophia Reisinger. Von Reitzenstein. Von Letzo Vorbeck. Private attorney in his service to His Holiness Pope Francis documents. Related, the United States isn't a country. It's a corporation. Proof. Related, the United States isn't a country. It's a corporation. Proof. Vatican owns corporate United States, the hidden Vatican Crown Empire.
That's that corporation. Is that your debt?
No.
Can there be an encumbrance placed on you to reclaim your lost estate that was taken under fraud?
No.
Why do we keep jumping through these hoops every time they offer you a new taffy? No. In the case we don't understand the history, nor do we understand the law, nor do we understand that they're dealing with a global world trust. And the heirs of the estate must competently speak up. That's all you have to do.
Yeah, but a lot of us have signed off on these mortgage agreements thinking we get...
It matters not. It's a fraud. See, this is the whole deal. This is the deal. This is the deal. This is what's happening. And then we're going to close out. The people themselves have to start rendering unto Caesar what is Caesar's. You've got to stop rejecting this stuff. Stop feeding the beast. Your estate is returned to you, claim it. That's why you do a trust. Put your stuff in trust. Act competent. Cause the bonds to fall. That's what's going to get him off your back. You keep feeding him.
What happens when
it's amazing. It's amazing that we can't, our people just can't. A child can figure that out once they understand it. It's a fraud. Stop feeding him. The beast lives because you keep feeding him. Then he gives you a program to get out of the feeding because you're the food.
And
you keep buying into it. And he gives him jurisdiction because he doesn't have jurisdiction.
It's an illusion.
You know what he keeps saying? All I did was call you followed. So what you complaining about? And we keep doing it over again after we've been told the truth. We keep empowering him and then complain about him using the power.
I'm the mom.
Because we believe in him, that's why.
So we need to be educated and trust.
You gotta kill, you know, it's the straw man, I always say this. You can't capture the straw man because it's his. You must choke him. But if he can convince you that you're gonna capture him, then he can get you in the ring. Then you've opened your garment. So if he bites you, it's your fault for not wearing a turtleneck. Go ahead.
Alright. So can I record my allodial trust I've set up through my Great Seal of Government through the Association of the Moorish Affairs?
You can do that. Remember, when Duali set up the old Canaanite temple, he set up a trust for the people to do that. But the sellout, that's why it hasn't been done and that's why it hasn't been taught. Great Seal was just set up for people who get to that degree to give you some remedy. Since the people around you won't do what they're supposed to do, but you got to take responsibility. It's sort of like this. The gate has been opened to liberate the people. They keep following their compromised leaders. They keep on trying to sell them a package, trying to feed off of them in the name of liberating them when a birthright can't be sold. As soon as you do that, you've contaminated because now divine law won't protect you because you're violating divine law. Because you must honor your mothers and your fathers that your days may be longer upon the earth land. You can't sell it. So you want to sell it, then you get screwed. Now you want to start another program to fix what you just keep on breaking. You get the point? And since those who haven't carried out the law haven't carried out the law, that is set up so that single units of beings have some remedy to start choking them bonds. Because as soon as you start making them claims, them bonds on Water Street start curling up. You don't have to capture it, you kill it. They hypothecate it. Is that not a spiritual act? Are they physically touching your property? They hypothecate it, didn't they? Well, guess what? Reverse hypothecate. Rehypothecate. Choke that straw man. Don't try to capture him. You're not going to capture him. Rule of law. Rule of law. In any form of government, does a clerk of any office anywhere under the jurisdiction of the United States, municipal, state, or federal, give up any original documents to anyone?
No.
So what makes you think you're authenticating some damn birth certificate?
Shut up.
Dummies.
Triangle.
And what is the argument in law? An argument in law, in estate and trust law, and right of claim holder in due course. Holder in due course must have original instrument. These people are so dumb. This European knows it. He offered them a tax and they start all over again. They'll be on the right path. 2 months. Men offer them another tax and they go. Where'd they go? And it gives it, and then we keep sending this crap to the next generation. Why do you think we ain't fixing nothing? Do you understand? I'm not saying that we're not going to have problems. But the problems we have is for what we have not done the generation before. Take the hit. Save your babies. You understand? Save your babies. World's tired of you. World is tired of this nigger problem. They won't let you get wiped out if you keep it up. Islam.
Thank you.
They are.
As Islam, you mentioned earlier that there's going to be, we're going to lose, like it's going to be a lot of blood drop. Is that the speculation for bunches of people that's going to be taken to these FEMA camps? And
well, that's their plan. But the Manchurians have intentions of interrupting that. But that's not going to stop them from doing what you call false flags and bloodletting with the dummies that keep on getting in these marching crowds and stuff. You know, that think they're going to get some kind of benefit. Or think they don't understand the real history and they don't understand what they're operating off and think they're going to appeal to their moral character, which it has nothing to do with what's going on. You're dealing with empire. You're dealing with the Roman Empire falling. And they're going to be snatching anybody. It's sort of like a beast or an octopus that's drowning that ain't supposed to drown. And it, you know, the octopus in the water, he ain't supposed to drown, right? But he's drowning. And you swimming nearby, you look like a raft to them. He gonna put one of them tentacles on you and pull you down with him. You know, I'm pausing because I'm trying to think to have words for it. When the Rockefellers talk about making these people docile, his success rate is amazing because he has certainly done it. Our people are as naive as I don't understand. Right now, I'm lost for words, to be honest with you, which is usually doesn't occur.
Very true. As soon as you get on the phone with him, he takes advantage of the opportunity. You're on the phone for an hour and a half, so yes, true.
I'm really, but from a spiritual perspective, I see what I really don't want to see, and that's a lot of our people going to have to die. A lot of them going to have to die in order to make them accept the truth. Because they just don't want it. At least it gives that appearance. So that means they will be delivered to Rome by their own will. And believe me, he's going to devour them too. He will, absolutely.
I saw a sample a couple years ago. I need to share it with everybody. In Philadelphia, it was a guy who had a car, didn't have a Pennsylvania license, so they decided they were going to give him a hard time. So what happened was, we went to the court. I didn't really want to go, but I'm glad I did. And the lawyers were there setting everybody up, negotiating, but we've all been through it, right? And then when the judge came out, I know the judge, I helped him get elected. Man, I felt bad that day. She came out and they were all set up, they stood in line, and she chopped everyone's heads off. Everybody had to pay. It was ruthless. That was friendly. He's talking blood, people would actually be killed, but this was an example. Like a symbolism, and I was sorry I knew her, I was sorry I saw how that happen, but that's what made me turn more in this direction, to help get us straight, because they're ruthless. That's, I had
their food, their food. Their food. Listen, let's look at this honestly. Look at this honestly. What did old Drawley say about us in the fall? To fall the Moors. Part of the reason for our fall is because we violate our own principles and start doing things that, practicing those names and principles that delude to slavery and doing such things to gratify our lower selves. Yes. But we don't want the price that we pay.
Right.
You know, let's look in the Bible and then ask a few more questions, then we'll close out. 64-65 in Isaiah. It says, I hold my hand out all the day long to a hard-hearted and rebellious people who are not called by my name. When they repent from their sinful ways, I will hear from heaven and heal their land. His land is not in the state. Is this land, L-A-N-D, sound like a cloud?
No.
Isn't the clergy keep telling these people it's up there in the sky on a cloud? In the afterworld type stuff? But the book says land.
Yeah.
So they be saying, oh, we're in the world, not of the world type thing, as if they ain't got nothing to do with this. Meanwhile, they're taking everybody's coins.
Because
their gods are always broke.
Mm-hmm.
And the people keep falling for it.
Every Sunday.
You know, and all I'm saying is this. The Pope owns all the corporations. He's telling you that there is no encumbrance. He's telling you that the states are restored to the geographical. Is that not land?
Yes.
Americans and American state citizens. That excludes U.S. citizens, which are corporate. Pope tells you. This whole fraud that started 150 years ago with the African Americans being used to back the U.S. corporate debt since in the wake of the Civil War. Is it not what I'm telling you? If you don't understand this, can you make a claim on that estate when you don't even know what the estate is? If you claim to be anybody outside of that venue, did he say Indians?
No.
Did he say sovereign white people?
No.
Did he say U.S. citizens?
No.
Who's this whole fraud and been backing his bonds? So-called African Americans. Who's them African Americans?
Moorish Americans.
Who is therefore, by law, the heirs and the people of the geographical Americas? What is he telling you? Meaning, if the Pope is telling you, and these people keep on running after these programs, there is no encumbrance. It was created in a fraud. It cannot, you can't get a positive out of a fraud. So the Pope, who owns the corporation himself, is doing what? Throwing them under the bus and telling you your estate is restored. Even he even writes estate in small case and uppercase. He even tells you the United States minor makes the distinction between United States minor and United States major. United States with a small U. The Pope is telling you the history. When I say you, I'm talking about plural. And what do? We now see the Viagra that didn't work before. We got a double pole one now. Unless you want pole vaulting, don't take it. For the Olympics, I'm suggesting you don't take it. Because it's probably permanent. We fall for everything, I'm telling you. Anyway, any more questions?
Yeah, not a question, but it's not a question, but it's just like something that happened out of the so we were doing our the proclamation. So as I said, we're like infants, we're just getting our bearings. So.
And let me say this to you. The reason we put that out there, trusting that people will study, because it really doesn't even need to be that long, but because we know that a lot of people don't really have a history background or law background, it is presented to be both a writ and a teaching tool at the same time. But it is to give a pattern so that one would have an idea what one is to do. But from an esoteric position, we know that once they're produced and they're out there, that it kills the bonds. That's the real deal. We know that people really don't, and it's not a knock on them, don't really understand this thing. So it's sort of like a helper, and where the air is demonstrating that you have an idea, a competent idea of what's going on and what your claim of right is. But this is the key. The issue of, go ahead. So the issue is, everything concerning us, the Europeans claiming that we are abandoning our claim. By failing to claim is an abandonment of claim. By making that proclamation, it is in its nature an affidavit. They will not challenge it because they can't challenge it. Right. So they either try to just ignore it or try to discourage you. Because once that's stayed and that's out there, they're not going to tell you, but I am telling you. Once they start circulating, them bonds at 55 Water Street will start getting trouble. Because what's happening, this is what's been happening. They've created the bonds on our back and they've been selling them to other governments and funding that United States corporation company that Lincoln killed with it. That they've created these continuous shells to keep this fraud going on. When you start declaring your nationality and it's public, it demonstrates to the world that a competent heir is speaking up. The bond becomes toxic. It is already worthless anyway. But what gives it its value is that the heirs won't speak up. So their claim of abandonment stands until someone speaks up.
Too much sense.
Yeah. No,
I'm just telling you, this is all
too simple.
Everything that they're doing is based on abandonment. Any claim not made is abandoned. That's why it's called a proclamation. And it's also judicial, because you're making a lawful proclamation and notice. You're putting them on notice. You're claiming the rights. You ain't asking them for anything. They don't seal that. I seal it. Do you understand? So, you're the heir. Now, the Pope done told you now, as of, what, since 1913, the Popes have been backing up Noble Drawley. Now, if the heirs don't agree, they don't have to agree, do they? They've abandoned their estate, though, haven't they?
Yes, they have.
That's why the proclamations are out, because we know that, just like we have this meeting here, and people come here and there, and we know that they're getting different influences, and we know they have limited knowledge, and many of them, they put more energy in learning processes to try to get a cookie than they will studying the real history on how this stuff has happened to them. Therefore, people who see them, who know this history, can easily take advantage of, because as soon as they open their mouth, they'll tell you their degrees. They don't know that they're telling their degrees as soon as they open their mouth. And so while they're in this gray area in the fog, they can rape them. You know, they'll set a program, well, see, I can, you know, well, see, what you gotta do, you gotta get this UCC form filled
exactly
out.
What I was about
and
to
you only, no, only, just only in charge of a couple hundred for this one. And then, and as soon as you do that, then after that, oh, we got another part, then they need another 1500. Then they got another part. And then you bunch around a couple years, running around back to these offices and everything. Feel good, You learn a lot, though. Don't think you don't learn, because you learn a lot, but you don't still get the cookie. Yeah. So now after that runs for a couple of years, then they'll do a new program. This is why you came from HMOs to site drafts to UCCs to financial statements, now birth certificate. But they're all the same thing, trying to get a hold of that Sister QB Trust. They just changed the name for the same, it's just a different angle trying to get the same taffy. Meanwhile, the people in the middle, they getting a piece of your action because you ain't wake. You know what I mean? That's why I say, you know, you got a nice big taffy. Remember when we was growing up, you get them little taffies, you get those swirly taffies. Remember those swirly girls taffies? And nice wrapper on it's real big and everything. And you walking around with it and everybody trying to talk. Take the wrapper off. Don't take the wrapper off. Yeah, take the wrapper off. And then everybody, you know, what happened? Same thing, you know, if you're taffy, in the world of economics, do not walk through the mall without the wrapper. Because by the time you get out the other door, you thought you visited Jenny Craig and you didn't. Because you got licked.
That's that touchy room pop.
And it happened, and the interesting thing about it is that it happens over and over again, and you'll be looking at people that basically are intelligent. And they don't understand the difference between de facto and de jure. And they be saying it. They don't understand color law, and they be saying it. They be keep doing color things. It's amazing. It's absolutely amazing. It really is.
Let me tell you what happened. So we were getting the proclamation. So as I said, we were new to it. So seeing a Moor was like an honor, and oh my God, a country, you know, Moor, I don't know if you're a Moor. So we met this guy, and he was like, yeah, you know, about the tax sign my thing. I was like, I just need your signature, you know. I just need you to sign the email with me. So we went over there, and we were talking to this. Anybody doesn't come with us, we don't want to hear that. So he started talking about the temple and everything. So we started looking up like, here we go. And he started off good, and the next thing you know, he comes up with, so, you know, there's this guy on YouTube, and if I'm not following nobody that ain't wealthy, because whoever you follow, you need to look like them. So I said, Tosh could have been rich, but he don't want, he's not putting that black crap out there. You know what I'm saying? And if he was to chase his, do his thing, how would we get educated? He'd sacrifice his time to give to us, so we can in turn start becoming conscious heirs to the estate. And he starts telling us, well, you know, he said, if you authenticate the birth certificate and do the UCC. So she turns to me and goes, I'm not commerce. UCC, it's commerce. And how are you going to say you're denouncing the birth certificate when you do the proclamation, but then turn around back again and say, well, I'm not that, but hey, I'm that again. So it just showed me what nobody really said.
Let me tell you, this is the offer. This is the offer. And then we'll close out. If the Romans can get you to sign anything with the promise of a benefit, of a penny, and get you to agree, thinking you won't get a penny, you just let them off the hook for future suit of reparations, because you just made a contract for a benefit, therefore you're closed out. That's one more apple off the tree. In other words, another disinherited. See, because this is the thing of law. If something is a fraud, you must claim it a fraud. If they can get you to authenticate the fraud, then they are justified. Because now you authenticated, it's no longer categorized as a fraud.
Even if you don't have knowledge of everything,
it doesn't matter. See, this is the deal. If you know this much about the bonding against us, if you know that much, and you signed an instrument, you signed it in a state of competence.
So what if you don't know?
Well, you better argue it that you didn't, and you better do a rescission of signature. You know, it's like this, and I'm going to say this. When our people learn that they're not Negro, Black, and colored, when they learn the distinction between fiat and money, and they learn the difference between the Constitution for the United States and the Constitution of the United States, and that coup d'etat, at that point they're responsible. Mean that once you awaken, you're responsible. And if you get attracted by the tablets he offers you, you just become a sacrifice. Why do you think they've been starting this authenticating the birth certificate? No, let's keep it very, very simple. Let's keep it very, very simple. How many European sovereignty groups that have been operating in the last 15 to 20 years that have had classes where people have been spending 1,500 to 3,600 notes? They've been calling dollars for these classes and jumping through these hoops and run through them. And the few people that have gotten to the degree of the voucher, because remember the debts are really the United States Corporation Company, they're supposed to actually discharge. You're supposed to actually have a voucher. So people who perfected UCCs and got vouchers, as soon as they try to use the vouchers, then they threaten their lives. Consider this, any of you who know anything about anything. I can go back into dealing with Europeans and some Asiatics who've been dealing with these principles for the last 30 years, going back to when it was called HMOs, and then site drafts, and then also certificates sent to the transportation department, all this kind of stuff. But they're essentially different angles to the very same thing. Why has this been going on for 25, 30 years heavily, although it always went on before? Because it's been buying them time. And I'm telling you, with all the different operations and people who have been dealing with this instrument, I challenge anybody, anywhere, to show me five people that have perfected the processes and that is published.
Five.
Within 25
or 30 years.
Name five. Including the people. Let's look at this. And use your common sense, Dr. Nyland. If I perfected the process, whereas I'm dealing with the vouchers and I've captured the straw man, and therefore all it needs is my signature, why would I need 1,500 from you to get you started? That's like a man who just learned, that just has the ocean, talking about if you need a swimming pool, everybody needs some swimming pool, needs to bring a bucket of water to me. I don't need it. It's a headache. It's like a wheat farmer saying, in order for your family to be fed, you gotta bring a loaf of bread. No, I don't have nowhere to put it. They're naive, they're like little boys and girls. A man who's achieved it all doesn't need that. Almost all of these people who've got these packages to sell, they make their finance by the people who's promised the process on the package they gotta sell them. And it's not that the process or the story of how these processes are supposed to morally and ethically take place. It's not that the card game doesn't read out like it's supposed to be successful, it just never is. And so now it's the birth certificate because they then ran through the UCCs and then hit the wall so many times people didn't figure out it's a Ponzi scheme. So they got another angle, that's all it is. The same way it was before when it was HMOs, then it becomes UCCs. It's the same Sister Q V-Trust, the same transmitting utility. They just change the names and keep the same program on. This is all I'm saying to you. Anybody that knows anybody, name five people that's perfected the system. And if it's just and it's for everybody, why aren't the masses already there? Why are they only there? And why is something that's so fundamentally right so complex? And why do you complete one cycle, then you wait a few months, you go through, jump through the hoops, and everybody screws you around, and then when you start getting some successes, then they boot you out or block you, and then now somebody goes, oh, well now, so see, you got that right, but now we got, and then they add something else to it, then you gotta do something else, you gotta jump through another hoop. The Pope is telling you don't have to jump through the damn hoops. It's a fraud, that's what the Pope is telling you. It's returned to you with no encumbrance. The fraud started over 150 years ago. You're used to back the U.S. corporation's debt. It ain't your debt. All right? Any more questions? Or we got to get rid of them.
I had one more. No.
You all right?
Article 3 deals with the judicial powers. So I'm in the middle of a suit, and you know how we CC everything out to all the other nations around the world. So I got a reply back from, let me read this, from the Supreme Court office clerk. So they said, in reply to your letter of submission received, I regret to inform you that the court is unable to assist you in this matter that you present. Under Article 3 of the Constitution, the jurisdiction of the court extends only to consideration of cases or controversies properly brought before it from lower courts in accordance with federal law and filed pursuant to the rules of this court. Your papers are here with the return.
Yeah.
So are they saying that I should take it to
what they're telling you that they're not government.
Yeah, exactly. So the now is...
Meaning they can't enforce the Constitution because they're not damn government. And they're BSing you around. Now this goes back to you killing their bonds. This is why we tell people, start putting liens against their bonds. They're done in Bradstreet and their bonds. And this is back to even why Grace Hill Order was set up to give people an understanding of the imperial divan, rather than sex with the structure of government, the real history, come together, this is what your organizations are for. This is how the temples were supposed to be used. Yeah. What is Act One of the Moorish Science Temple of America? Chairman and moderator, which converts into what? Sheikhs and grand sheikhs?
Yeah.
Sisters and grand sheikhs are put in power to do what?
Enforce law.
To make law and to enforce law. Have they been doing it?
No.
What have they been telling the people that you all need to teach civics, didn't they?
Yeah.
And they've been getting away with it happening.
Yep.
So now, you understand why Great Seal exists? So now it's incumbent upon you, us, we, to teach others and to bring competent people together to get these things done. No different than we're talking with each other. We go, say, with Haru to a class Haru's doing or something like that, right? Or that him and D's doing. Then the people who learn under them become qualified to come together to take care of these things because no man's an island. And so when you look at the charters, what does it say? USA, right?
Yes.
Unity, salvation, Allah.
Yep.
If the people would use the tools, put it this way, don't our people spend finance, time, and energy and service to deal with a lot of different organizations and they do it dedicatedly for years? So it ain't like they ain't been putting finance out, and it ain't like they ain't putting time out. What happens is they keep putting their time and energy in organizations that actually don't deal with the real issue that injures them. That's where your problem is. So it's not about the finance or the time, it's about misdirection, isn't it? And proper allocation of both time and finances, isn't it? That's why Great Seal exists. However, you can't make people do what is obviously sensible for them to do, because they won't stay dedicated. They want the benefit without the dedication. there's both your dilemma and your answer. So if you can get the people to stop being passive, this is why Drawley said, I want active Moors, not passive Moors. Why? Because passive Moors will end up being enemy to the cause. Now, meanwhile, and I'll say this again, for the people that we deal with around the country, we try to make them conscious to the degree that they at least make proclamations because we know it's going to kill the bombs. Even while they're not active necessarily to the degree that they need to be, them stock market starts curling up. And all you need is a number of them. And so while we're going about our business learning, the European can't hold on to power because nobody wants to buy his derivatives or his bonds because they're dead. They're being choked. You don't have to capture them. You choke them. You need to know how to. Because you'll never get your hand on them. They will never give you an original anything. So why worry about that? Why jump around trying to capture something you're not going to capture? Choke it. They hypothecate it, you rehypothecate it. Except you have right. So if the heir is proclaiming, then they can't keep on claiming to represent you, can they? Can they? And if they can't represent you, they're trying to represent you, sell these bonds to nations around the earth, and you're putting out these proclamations and CCing them all over the damn place. The bonds start dying. So you have to argue with them. You need to be active, don't you? And it starts killing the bonds. And after a while, you get enough people. Don't take the whole nation. All you need is a handful. You know how they say, Kabbalistically, almost in any really good war, just give me, I don't need a big army, give me 10 good men. But they're talking about sincerity and bravery. They're not talking about, you don't need a crowd. You need sincere people, and you need sincere energy that goes in the ethers. It has power unimaginable. Any more questions, y'all? Well, thank you all for coming out to the House of Reawakening Minds. Don't forget, pass the word around, and if you have any spare finances, make sure you send it down and keep the house open. Because the support systems that were here are no longer here, all right? And so the burden to keep this house open is on her back. So let everybody know. And also come on the show. Tell them about your show so they can come on the show too.
Reawakening Minds airs every Monday night on High Frequency Radio Network, 8 p.m. to 11 p.m. Eastern. You can go to www.blogtalkradio.com/high frequency, or you can call in area code 424-222-5250 to hear the show. Next week, part two of my interview with Richard Smith, the European who wrote The War, the Mason and the Alien. He's coming out with a new book, part two, and he will be on the show next Monday. Yeah, Monday is coming up on the 10th. At 8 p.m. Check that out.
All right. Thank you all for coming out. Peace.